going to do is we are taking Rasa SNAP solution from the main tank and brings it back to the buffer tank. So whatever liquid is required for the complete closed loop, that is only heated and cooled. So there, you know, we already are saving the energy. So that is already addition in the industry, which a lot of people have already adopted.
That's wonderful. That's wonderful. Thank you, sir. Thank you. Important as an announcement. Our conference material is being received today at night. So please also come in morning and collect that kit and souvenir and other materials, you know, tomorrow morning. And please, those who are absent or not present here, then please be informed all that they should come in morning and collect the conference kit. Thank you very much. Now, Dr. Ravi Kumar.
Reliable technologies. We given the various advantages of automation, we specified the difference between instrumentation and automation, and how instrumentation, which was the part of the dairy equipments earlier, can be used for better control, effective use, to lead, which may ultimately lead to automation and ultimately savings. So it's a wonderful presentation he made on the need of automation in dairy side, various opportunities available for saving as been specified, and budding dairy engineers and plant managers can take note of it. The next presentation was from Mr. Dr. A.S. Kojari, Aurangabad. He specified the need for backward and forward linkage for maintaining supply chain and introduction of automation and need for providing engineering solution for providing better backward and forward linkage. And very nicely he presented all the aspects of communication systems, quality of the milk at the farm level, and transportation during transportation as well as to the dairy. Next presentation was by Dr. P. Barnwal, Principal Scientist at DRI. Thermic fluid based heating systems. As now there is need to improve the working conditions also for better food safety management systems, there is need to eliminate direct steam fumes. So he's given his presentation on use of thermic fluid for heat transfer. So this presentation was very nicely taken. It's high time that we should replace direct steam or indirect steam heating with thermic fluid system, because it's energy efficient as well as it gives better taste and texture to some of the dairy products. Next presentation was by Dr. Chitra Nayak, Senior Scientist, regarding the advantage of application of automation in processing dairy. The presentation was basically covered the theoretical aspects of the automation, loop control systems, and it covered all the theoretical aspects as well as how to convert the feedback system to manage the dairies better way, to have savings in the system, to have better controls. And next presentation was by Dr. J.K. Dabas, energy management for enhancing the profitability in dairy industry. So ultimately, gentlemen, it is the profitability which we can pay the CEO, that how much saving has been done. He listed the various opportunities, whether it is homogenization, whether it is CIP, whether it is pressurization, or whether it is refrigeration, which is the major, where the maximum energy is being consumed in dairy and food processing industry. He clearly specified the consumption of energy in food scenario, food industry as well as dairy industry. Last but not the least presentation was by Honorable Dr. Ravi Kumar on bulk milk pooling use and misuse. Generally, government is stressing all upon the whether it is a village-based milk procurement system or NDP or NPDDP. Various government programs, they emphasize the need of bulk milk pooling systems at village level. But we at Punjab, even at all, they are feeling the ill effects, that is misuse, which is specified, ill effects of the bulk milk pooling system which are being installed at the villages. And it's high time that some task force may be constituted at the government level to provide some SOPs for better operation of bulk milk coolers at farm level, at society level rather. Because he very rightly said that our aim was to maximize the use of the capacity. For that, what we do, we link the neighboring villages with the BMC. I think Dr. Saab agree with that, to fully utilize the capacity of the BMC. Generally, there is a trend to link a surrounding village with that BMC. So, with this, the pooling takes place very slowly, whereas instant milk pooling is required, and he suggested for heat exchanger based pooling system to supplement the effect of BMCs, so that there may be better keeping quality in case that milk is processed for long shelf life products. Thank you very much, sir. I thanks all the speakers for giving the wonderful presentation. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Devji, with this we come to end. There was, of course, due to limitation of time, there was no question answer session. Anybody has any questions, speakers will be there. You can please clear your doubts. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Agrawala sir, Sanjeev Sharma sir, Chaudhary sir, for concluding this session and all the speakers. Thank you very much. There is a 10 minutes tea break, and immediate after tea break there will be oral presentation for young research scientists. So, P.A. Chauhan, my project is design, development and performance evolution of SSHG for manufacture of tea. As we aware that tea is cereal based, desiccated product and in nutritious product, a systematic work on the development of suitable equipment for mechanized production of such product was not recorded. The study was planned. The objective of study were to design and develop an SSHG for the manufacture of tea and to evaluate the performance of design SSHG during manufacture of tea. The methodology was used in the research project. First was the development of scratch surface heat exchanger. In designing of SSHG, there are main three components: productive rotor scraper assembly, drives for scraper assembly. So in productive, the productive was manufactured jacketed, as we have used steam in the jacket for heating purpose. Jacket was the productive was manufactured from 5 mm thick AISI 304 SS plate, and the lead of the productive was manufactured from 10 mm thick AISI 304 plate stainless steel. The length of the productive was 600 mm and diameter 500 mm. The cover of it, the jacket was covered by 50 mm length of overall, and 25 mm length of the productive was provided on the both sides. The second is rotor scraper assembly. It was manufactured from 25 mm diameter shaft, and four scraper were provided with spring and teflon blades. And third is drive mechanism. So in drive mechanism, AC motor with reduction gear box was provided, and the reduction ratio of the gear box was 15:1. The method for manufacture of kheer was used as the standardized pasteurized milk was taken in SSHG, and we have to start the scraper and steam supply in the system, and heating of the milk to boiling, addition of rice at 3% of the milk, cooking, concentration, after concentration addition of sugar at 8% of milk, and addition of cardamom and saffron, unloading, filling cups and storage at refrigeration temperature. In performance evaluation of SHSE parameters for, we have used Faber speed as 10, 20 and 30 RPM, operating steam pressure 1.5 and 2 kg per centimeter square, and batch size 10, 15 and 20 kg. The data were analyzed by factorial CRD, three factors. This is the technical diagram of the SHSE. This is the top view, elevation and side view of the system. We can see that this is productive. On the top, we have provided one blower to remove the vapor at faster speed. This is the drive mechanism for rotating the scraper, and the motor was provided with the VFD to change the RPM of the system. As we see that scraper was provided with rod, and on the rod we have provided spring, and on that one pipe is provided, and those pipes are connected with Teflon plates for scraping of the product. This is the actual system was installed in the Dairy Engineering Department at Dairy Science College, AU Anand. This is productive, and this productive was provided, we have provided the holes on the top for removal of vapor at faster rate, and on the this top we have provided electrical motor with blower to remove the vapor. This photograph shows the scraper in the system. The data sensory evolution was done at different combination of parameters. Total 27 trials were taken, and it was compared with the control product, and we have observed that P1, P3, S3, that means 1 kg per centimeter square pressure, 30 kg of base size, and scraper speed of 30 rpm was, we got the maximum overall acceptability at 8.14 score. The U value of the SHSE was also analyzed at different scraper speed, and it was found 913 to 1228 watt per meter square Kelvin in different combination of parameters, as well as effect of batch size on U value during heat making, and it the same value we have observed. The conclusion of the project: the SHSE developed can be successfully used for mechanization of heat. The process parameters, which include steam pressure, scraper speed and batch size, can be easily controlled in order to obtain desirable attributes in the product. The Teflon edge plate provide efficient scraping of the material adhered on the heat transfer surface and noiseless operation. And the quality of heat prepared in SHSE under the operation condition P1, P3, S3 was found superior in terms of sensory attributes as compared to the products prepared at other operating conditions of the SHSE. Thank you.
Okay, next speaker, Engineer Ankit Deep, to speak on design and performance evaluation of CIP system for three-stage SHSE.
So this study was designed with two objectives. The first one was to design and fabricate the cleaning in clay system for three-stage scrap surface heat exchanger, and another project objective was to evaluate the performance of fabricated cleaning in clay system for three-stage scrap surface heat exchanger. Now in these two objectives, it was targeted that the overview of the target system should be such that the CIP system should fit into the available space. Besides the available equipment, which is scrap surface heat exchanger 3-stage in this pattern, and the schematic concept, conceptual diagram of this CIP system was conceptualized as it would be having three main tanks, which would be one of raw water tank, another one for lye tank, and the third one for acid tank. So these three would be for this working solutions. And they would be pumped by a CIP forward pump with the two sensors connected. One of the sensors, which is shown here at number 2, would be an electrochemical sensor, which would would be for measuring the pH, whether it is acid or lye or what pH it is, so that we can have a consideration regarding the concentration of the supplied solution. Then this three number is a temperature sensor, which would be a PT100, and before this three number there is a DSI system, direct steam injection. And then from the process means SSHG, there would be a third line coming back and with the sensor, which would be an electrical conductivity sensor to sense whether the return coming line is with the fluid which was forwarded or is it having a lesser concentration, so that we can have an indication to when to stop CIP or when to change the step of CIP. And then on the basis of the sensor's output, it would be either recovered or drained to the drains. And for filling of these three tanks, we would have a raw water source for raw water tank, concentrated lye and concentrated acid tanks, which would be having smaller capacities. So with this concept, a hold-up volume of the existing equipment was studied using three higher flow rates, which was 350, 450 and 528 kg per hour flow rate of water, and keeping high steam pressures and scraper speed. Steam pressures were kept as 3.5, 2.5 and 1 kg per centimeter square in scraper 1, 2 and 3, which is stage 1, 2 and 3. And RPMs were 200, 175 and 40 RPM for scrappers SSHG 1, 2 and 3. And it was found that the hold-up volume was varying between, in these variations, it was between 5 to 10 liters. So it was suggested that we should keep at least 4 times the volume and for 4 minutes of circulation time. So based on 10 liter volume, it was designed to have 150 liter compartment. So to have 150 liter compartment, about 15% was increased so as to have a over capacity build up, and 200 liter capacity was for water, lye and acid tanks. So these three tanks were designed for 200 liters capacity each, and concentrated lye and acid tanks were designed to have 50 liters capacity. So total tank capacity was 700 liters. So based on that, this type of multi-partition compartment tank was built at NDRI Karnal in the research and development workshop. It was fabricated, and then electronic circuit diagram was also made to sense the high, medium and low level of all the 5 tanks. So 15 LEDs were connected in this particular manner shown in the central figure, and this was the circuit diagram of the control panel also assembled at Dairy Engineering Division only. After that, these sensors were calibrated, and one of the sensor, pH sensor, was programmed using open source software, which is Arduino IDE. And other sensors, electrical conductivity sensor and PT100 was with their own controllers. So this was how the sensors were mounted on the lines. This is showing the sensor should be protruding inside the line so that the CIP solutions can be monitored online. This is electrical conductivity sensor, this is temperature sensor, and this is the pH sensor. Then this was the finally assembled control panel, which is showing this meter is for electrical conductivity, this is for temperature, and this one is a LCD screen which was programmed using Arduino IDE, and these are 15 LEDs for sensing high, medium and low level of all 5 compartments individually, and these buttons are for pumps. The pump, there were 4 pumps, 2 were for forward and return and 2 were for supplying concentrated solutions to the dilute solution tanks. This is the CAD drawing of the fabricated CIP system. So it is showing the 5 compartments are there, and these are 2 smaller pumps for pumping the concentrated solution to the diluted solutions. This is CIP forward pump, this is CIP return pump, and this is inline filter in the return line. And these positions 10, 11 and 12 are showing the position of the 3 sensors. Now this is the overall look of the fabricated CIP system. This system is sitting behind this 3-stage scrap surface heat exchanger, and this is how the experimental flow diagram was conceived so as to have a performance evaluation. So up till now, the first objective was complete, and for completing the second objective, PROA was prepared, and we have taken multiple trials using RSM. So this RSM technique was used for using FCC. Light concentration varied from 0.75 to 2%. Temperature of the solution was ranging from 60 to 80 degrees Celsius, and scrapper speed was from 150 to 300 RPM for all three scrappers simultaneously. These were the responses, the ANOVA table which we got from the RSM trials, and it was showing that the quadratic model was selected with significant fit, and this is significant for light time, total CIP time, TCP and polyform. So these four were the our output parameters. Now this is the regression coefficient table which is showing the relationship between the light time, CIP time, TCP polyform, along with the process variables which were concentration, temperature and speed, along with this R square values. So these all R square values are greater than 80% or around 80%, which is showing a good fit. Now the optimized parameters which were obtained for this CIP system was concentration 0.85%, temperature 72.7 degrees Celsius, speed 150, which are leading to light time of 326 seconds, total CIP time of 1648 seconds, and TCP and polyform not detectable. Now these trials were also validated using a formula given by Lohmer et al, and it was showing that the experimental values were corresponding to the predicted value, and the model can be called as fit. Now conclusion for this was that we can have a CIP system which is wheel mounted, and it can be also used for another CIP systems. And a future application could be that it can be also tested for other equipments, and it can also be modified into an automatic control system.
Speaking on performance evaluation and energy saving in a boiler of a large dairy plant.
Engineer friends, today I am myself Patel Himanshu. I am assistant professor in dairy engineering department from MIDFT. My topic is on performance evaluation and energy saving in boiler of a large dairy plant. Today in Gujarat, every dairy use thermal energy in form of steam, hot water and hot air. About 60% of share of thermal energy is from the boiler, that is from steam for milk and milk product processing. A typical boiler will consume many times the initial capital expense in fuel usage annually. That means initial cost of, for example, if initial cost of boiler is 2.5 crore, then annual fuel consumption of that boiler is about 2 to 3 times that capital cost. So in boiler performance evaluation, the big term is boiler efficiency. We have to improve always boiler efficiency. Boiler efficiency includes every efficiency, that is combustion efficiency, thermal efficiency, okay? And it is very precise and accurate term for calculating cost accounting in terms of saving in money. Major factors affecting boiler efficiency are incomplete combustion, that is originated from improper combination of air and fuel ratio, or we can say shortage of air supply. Second major component is fouling of heat transfer surface, that means originated from when water evaporated, it gets concentrated, means TDS get accumulated on the heat transfer surfaces, and it reduces efficiency of the boiler. next parameter is poor operation and maintenance, and then last one is poor fuel quality and water quality. So there are two methods for boiler efficiency measurement. First is direct method and second is indirect method. First method is also we learned from our BTEC syllabus, that is output input method. And the second method is also known as loss method, heat loss method. First method has very advantages and also disadvantages, that we can calculate quickly with fewer parameters, using fewer parameters. And the major drawback of this system is that we can't find any losses from these equations. If we get 75 efficiency of the boiler, 525 losses occurs we cannot find from this formula. Second method is very accurate and less errors in measurements and clues given for heat losses. But the main major disadvantage of this method is it will provide only instantaneous value. And some parameters like standby losses, blowdown losses, auxiliary equipment energy consumption not counted in this method. There are 8 factors for solid fuel, 6 factors for liquid fuels. L1 to L6, L1 is for dry flue gas loss, that is heat carried away by flue gases. Second is loss due to hydrogen, H2 present, that is evaporation of water in flue gases, that heat current carried away by evaporation of water. Third is loss due to moisture in fuel, means extra energy required to evaporate the moisture from the fuel. And fourth, loss due to moisture in combustion air, so preheating of air required. And five, loss due to carbon monoxide. Means carbon monoxide shows that in incomplete combustion. And L6 is loss due to surface radiation, convection and conduction. So L2 to L4 is high, mostly dependent on the fuel. We can change by design modification. So we have to change the fuel and we can minimize the L2, L3, L4. So I suggest L1 and L5 method. So these are the losses: air supply to boiler, fuel supply, water supply, and there are 5 and 6 losses. And measurements requirement for the boiler performance: flue gas analysis, that is O2 percentage and CO2 percentage present in flue gas, complete analysis of fuel before burning, flow rate measurements for steam, water, fuel, temperature measurement, flue gas, steam, makeup water, condensate water, combustion air, fuel, field water, pressure measurements of all water condition, that is TDS and pH. And last is gross calorific value of fuel. So these are the formula suggested by standards, that is British standard of boiler testing, standard ASME standard and IA standard for boiler testing. First is theoretical air requirement, second is excess air supply by putting the value of oxygen by analyzing from flue gas. That if we get 10% of oxygen from flue gas, by putting that 10% we get the excess air, and by multiplying this with 1 plus EA by 100 into theoretical air requirement, we obtain actual air supply as per the fuel requirement, combustion requirement. And by putting that, we obtain the percentage we lost due to dry fuels. So approaches for performance improvement are, first is auto blow down system. It is mandatory. It also includes heat loss, but it is mandatory. Second is economizer for boiler. Third one is O2 analyzer with modulating burner for excess air control. Third, use of agro-based briquette as fuel. used third method. Reduction in flue gas temperature by controlling the excess air. So we control the optimized level of excess air in flue gas, and we can reduce the temperature of flue gas. So we have analyzed a boiler in year 2016 with the PCRA auditor and collect the data. That is, annual furnace oil consumption is 19 lakh. Flue gas temperature, final temperature 177 degrees centigrade, and oxygen in presence in flue gas is 13%. So we have suggested that if we reduce, we use oxygen analyzer in flue gas line, and we control flow of blower speed by variable frequency drive, we can reduce the percentage of oxygen in that flue gas. And in this slide, 22 degrees centigrade reduction in flue gas lead to 1% increase in boiler efficiency. So we have reduced 17 degrees, and we get 0.773% improvement in boiler efficiency. And saving in terms of money, 3 lakh.
Next speaker is Mr. Shubham Thakre. Please come on back.
Technology for the wind chilling. And the second objective is to apply the energy management tools for the performance evaluation of the various engineering interventions. In this, we are performing two activities. One is activity one is thermal performance evaluation of refrigerant system, and second is to calculate the cost economics of the system. The question may come in your mind, what is this VFD, that is variable frequency. Basically, this is a motor controller which regulates part of the fouling, corrosion classification of the type of the fouling in power field. These are the major classifications, and basically in our milk industry, the fouling, the precipitation type of the fouling and the power field fouling, that are generally widely we can investigate in our milk and milk processing. These are the factors, basically the factors that are affect on the milk fouling, that are compositions, operation conditions of the heat exchangers, type and the characteristics of the heat exchangers, that is very important. And the presence of the microorganisms, or you can say the biofilm generation, and the location of the fouling. Sometimes the location is so much remote that that cannot be easily removed by the CIP cleaning, and you have to do the maintenance or you can say the overhauling of the equipment. As Barton in 1967, that has indicated that is basically two types of the fouling that can be found in milk, and type A fouling and type B fouling. Generally, the type A fouling that is occurs in the pasteurization range, generally 75 to higher heating higher than the pasteurization 110, and basically it is composition wise. The scientist has analyzed the scale, and based on that, the compositional analysis has been done, and it is found that the majority type A fouling that is occurs due to the protein, and type B type of the fouling that is majorly occurs due to the minerals and dissolved materials that are present into the milk. So, these are the effects of the different components of the milk fouling. However, there is a long list, but we are not going to the in detail how that chemistry that has been occurred. The Kg mices, as the Kg mices is increases and the dispersibility of the Kg mices is disturbed, the fouling is increases. Serum protein, basically the beta-lactoglobulin and whey protein, that is broadly affects on the fouling. As the beta-lactoglobulin content is increases and the fouling is increases. Aging of the milk is one of the important factor. As the milk is loses its freshness. Freshness is means more the milk has been stored, the more proteolytic bacteria generates the enzymes, and that will lead to have the fouling into the milk. During the processing, and minerals more the minerals upon the heating that are making the combinations or conjunction with the protein that make it the solid particles, and that can be stuck on the heat surface area, and that can cause the fouling. Apart from that, the air bubbles present into the milk or dissolved gases that can also affect on the fouling. As the air bubbles is dissolved gases is increases, the fouling rate is also increases. Serum protein is again the important factor. Beta-lactoglobulin and how it affects reacts with the other component, it can also increase the fouling. Whey protein, and in a general way, if you have the high whey protein, you can easily remove the CIP phosphate reduced. But upon the higher heating, the whey protein gets denatured, and that is converted and attached with the minerals by making the aggregation, and that cannot be easily removed. And one of the important is the CIP. If the CIP is not covered, then also the fouling that can be affected. The operation conditions of the heat exchanger, ideally if you see the heat exchanger, generally plate heat exchanger and tubular heat exchanger that are widely used in the industry or dairy industry, and they are more prone to have the fouling because of its narrow passage between the two plates, higher the flow rate and the delta T is higher. So because of that, the geometry and the design of that heat exchanger that can also affect the fouling. The fouling that can be enhanced by adding the air bubbles, if that more processing pumping has been done more, then also the aeration also leads to the increasing the fouling. Higher the turbulence will reduce down the fouling. So if the processing parameters which are having the less turbulence, or when the heat exchanger having the not properly designed, then also the fouling that can be increased. The type and characteristics of the heat exchanger, the plate heat exchanger, generally fouling is because of the narrow channel. The milk fouling in a heat exchanger is difficult to completely eliminate, but needs to be having the higher reduced control over the time temperature combinations to reduce down the fouling. Heat transfer surface area, that is also important sometimes. So when in remote locations or some dead ends, that creates a biofilm formation, and that can also increase the fouling. And the factors that may affect the SS surface. SS surface is one of the most important things because nowadays if the surface roughness is also surface roughness is provided to the increase the biofilm formation, and that leads to make the fouling into the heat exchanger. So another, the microbial film, or that is due to the continuous processing or in adequate CIP system, the biofouling generation, okay, and biofouling that can also be affected into the performance of the heat exchanger. And the prevention methods, there are lots of prevention methods. We can avoid the over preheating, reduce down the aging of the milk, degassing of the milk that can be done before it taking into the heat exchanger, and sometimes sedimentation can be removed by additional heat treatment that has been given, and by applying injection or infusion type of the method that can also be reduced down the fouling. Now novel method like microwave or UF or ultrafiltration or UV that can also reduce down the fouling. Modifications on the plate geometry or heat exchangers. These are the ways indicators to having the fouling, pressure drop, temperature, heat transfer surface, electrical parameters, acoustic methods, and the various simulation and also the fouling modules. That can also. And if you can say, being the most important thing as a dairy engineer, the fouling modules that
time is over.
Okay. Zero fouling and anti fouling SS material that can be is a new trend.
Myself Ravi Prajapati. I am working as an assistant professor at G.R. Patel College of Dairy Technology. If any questions is there, then we can discuss later. So starting with the introduction, if we see the definition of sense, it is a faculty by which body perceives an external stimulus. We get sense by, we perceive anything by sense. So basically the five senses which are we are having, that is the sight, smell, hearing, taste and touch. So majorly we are using for sensory analysis. And sensory analysis is one of the major part for product development, research, as well as any kind of development required in dairy and food industry. We consider sensory analysis as a important analysis. So, but if you see the limitation. also a descriptive, because someone feels that the product have a defect, but it will not come into a account, but they may give her his or her comments on the product. So it can be a descriptive type. It may vary from consumer to consumer, and it may vary human being and with its condition, because weather changes may your feelings change and you sense differently. So if we see the role, I do not have to discuss more about the role of sense, but yes, if we see the eye will sense color, shape, size and many more, but majorly these three parameters it is going to analyze. That nose, it perceives the odor and aroma. Tongue will perceive taste and flavor. And if we hearing, if we see the sound of crushing the chips and biscuits, then some sounds comes in our ear by when we masticate them. And the last one is the sense we feel, we touch. When we touch, we feel something. So these are the, and we have to correlate that particular sensory into an analytical technique. So for that we have developed, it is already developed, but we have to use it for the artificial sense. So what is the need? I'm here targeting the need. What is the need? Requirement of rapid analysis, because we require specialized panel. The data gathered after the sensory evolution, that will be either in numerical, either in comment form. So we have to convert it into a, like hedonic scale, we have to convert it into a scorecard, or scorecard we have to convert into a points. So that can be eliminated. The reproducibility, repeatability varies from person to person, so that can be also avoided. Lack of facility of sensory personnel. If you see the super taster for tea, they are paid with high amount, so they require specialized skill for checking the quality of tea. So we require super taster in the case of product development and new research. Then again, analysis time, we require time, also the weather conditions, and latterly the manipulation, because something error will come, then we have to manipulate if in case required. So targeting this needs, I am going to cover first of all e-nose. The electronic nose is an instrument designed to analyze odor and volatile organic compounds either in gaseous or volatile form. It is just as an array of non-specific chemical sensors distinguishing the pattern of response from the gaseous or evaporated from liquid. The volatile compound gets sensed by the sensor, that is particularly metal oxide semiconductor sensor. And if you see, our brain will work like neurons will transmit to the olfactory bulb, and then it transmit the response to brain. Similarly, the same concept will be converted into an artificial sense, that is sensory array we have, sensor array we have developed, and that chip will, that data will transfer to the chip, and then it is transferred to a computer. The same will be represented as our brain is getting while we are doing sensory. So this is the conceptual diagram. If you see the food sample in here, when we are, the first food sample we are placing here, and fresh air we have, if we can apply, this is particularly technology developed by the Alpha MOS. So if you see, fresh air will evacuate the system first, and thereafter the sample, brain sample, will be analyzed. The sensor array will sense the volatile compounds of the product. Again, the valve 1 will close, and from valve 1 to valve 2, the volatile compound will be sensed and transmit the signal to the verification program. At certain set value and present value will be considered as a recipe, and we have to connect the interface, and that data will be displayed on LCD. If you see the instrument, Here it is shown, in case anything pre-treatment required for sampling, that we have to do before the placing, before placing the sample. If you see the component of ENOS, then it is already covered, but it is 16 MOS, as it is an array. If you see the advantage, the wide spectrum of response, sensitive, durable, easy to replace, and inexpensive. These are the some of the advantages I have covered. I am going to cover again E-term, the second most important sense. If you see, the same concept will be utilized for the patent, like the taste in the mouth will be considered as a signal, and that can be sensed by the amperometric sensors. There are four class of sensors that we can use for the analysis. When E-tongue and E-nose combine together, it will be a even better combination and it give better result. The E-nose and E-tongue system can combine and get a data sheet.
Maybe your time is over.
That's good. Later is EI. If you see the image analysis and spectrophotometric analysis and other ultra imaging technology, then the same will capture the image of particular size, shape and color will be distinguished, and that can be analyzed in form of data. Similarly, after EI, it gives an electrical current, like signal in form of electrical current. When the product is crushed and chewed, when formed. So, not taking much time, this is the scenario currently, these are the technologies available.
Please conclude. Time is already
so,
1 minute over.
Finally, concluding, it can replace the human expression, it can establish the ability of different basic tastes. It is almost a rapid technology and has a high sense of reproducibility and repeatability. Significant role in detection and identification, and also can be used for inline and standalone system. Thank you.
Myself and then my research work. So my name is Dr. G.S. Meena, Ganga Sai Meena. I am a scientist. Start having certain positive effect of what on the limited duration 19 to 25. Zeta potential shows the stability of the protein. The charge, there is the charge, where is the stability. Particle size is changing, there is no change in instability. Turbidity is reducing, pH is increasing as we are adding stabilizing salt, and viscosity is also rising because these are the cross-linking and stabilizing salt calcium chelator, basically. And the poor solubility of powders are very well positively correlated negatively correlated with the calcium content. If higher is the calcium content, lower will be the solubility. If the solubility is lower, then other functional property will be lower. So here my hypothesis that if I am adding these salts, that will lead to chelation of the calcium, that will lead to betterment of the solubility, and in reverse of that, it will improve other properties, functional property of that powder. So here, this is the comparison of these two powders. Here you can see, I have given the reference which we have published, that this is the control powder in which we have given only phosphorus and temperature, no salt were added, and these are the different physicochemical properties of this. And these are the properties of the powder which we have manufactured. So if we have a look on the this air content like OSC and ISC, occluded air content and interstitial air content, these are different. Then densities are different from control. Then the specific surface area. Now sir, I have written TS also. So if you see, in case of this control, TS is 18.44, in case of salt it is 19.37. If we go back to the basics of the drying, if TS content is changing, it will lead to change in the viscosity, and it will be changing particle size. If particle size is changing, it will be changing other properties also. Here also, you can see, if we are adding salts, pH is increasing, foaming will be enhancing. If foaming is enhancing, air inclusion will be enhancing, that will lead to different values of ISC and OSC, and because of that, these densities are changing. Now, particle size, this is the particle size or particle size distribution. So I am showing here D50 value. Probability is the dispersibility is significantly enhanced, and these are the water activity. Now coming to the functional property, this is very important that solubility has enhanced from 67 to around 83%. Viscosity is enhanced. Water binding capacity and on binding capacity are low because in native state, casein has property to bind more water and oil. While foam capacity and foam stability has significantly improved due to this intervention, and there is no impact on the stability. This is the rheological modeling. So it shows that either Postwald or Herschel-Buckley model can show or explain the rheological behavior. Here you can see, sir, in the same micrograph that there is no clustering or typical infusion of the powder particles, which is normally present in control powder, because of casein-casein interaction that lead to prevention of water ingress, and it leads to poor reconstitution property, which is absent in case of this. I have also determined buffering capacity. These are the I need to say that this intervention can significantly improve the solubility and other functional properties. It can replace control powder in a lot of product formulations. There are 880 products which are being used, which are being manufactured using MPC. And this powder which we have manufactured through this, that is better, have better functional potential. So it can be used in a lot of applications based on type of class of food like geriatric, sports, so many things. So that's it which I want to say. Thank you, right? And thank you.
Important environmental characteristics in dairy facility. Also, when light improves the operator efficiency and comfort and safety, and with the help of lighting, we can improve the cow performance and provide a safer in our cow dairy farm. Then come to the long day lighting. Long day lighting means photoperiod manipulation. Known as long day lighting. In long day lighting, we just leave the cow for.
So my topic of oral presentation is design upscaling of foaming milk heating system. As we all know that food is a basic component which is required by all the living beings for essential nutrition for their growth and for their life and growth. So there is need to process food to prevent, reduce or to eliminate various types of toxins and microorganisms that leads to various types of deteriorations. So in food industries, various types of conventional heating methods are used for the processing of food, and these conventional heating methods have certain limitations, like they have low heat transfer rate, which basically increases the cooking time and leads to surface hardening, high amount of heat losses, then heterogeneous heating due to internal resistance, which causes significant loss of product quality. So we need alternative technique to overcome the limitations of conventional methods, and ohmic heating is such an alternative technique which results in rapid and uniform heating of food. So ohmic heating is basically a novel method in which electric current is passed through a food material with primary purpose of heating by conversion of electrical energy into thermal energy that results in rapid and uniform temperature increase within the food and causes less thermal damage to food. So the basic principle behind ohmic heating is Ohm's law, which is a direct relationship between current and voltage. So this principle is basically based on generation of internal energy within the food material during heating. So rate of heat generation is directly proportional to the square of electric field strength and the electrical conductivity of material. So basically heat is generated because of the motion of ions and the collision between the ions, and this collision further increases the momentum transfer, which increases kinetic energy and hence generating heat within the food material. So the factors affecting ohmic heating. So large number of factors affect the ohmic heating, and the key parameter affecting ohmic heating is electrical conductivity. So generally for food material which are susceptible for ohmic heating, or ohmic heating is applicable to foods, those having electrical conductivity in range of 0.01 to 10 Siemens per meter, and electrical conductivity is directly proportional to temperature, as temperature increases, ionic mobility of the ions present within the food is also increases. Then third parameter is voltage gradient. As we all know that voltage gradient is the ratio of the rate of change of potential to the displacement. As the voltage gradient increases, ohmic heating time also increases. Then frequency, with increase in frequency, ohmic heating rate is of increases. Electrolytical concentrations. So electrical conductivity of the food material is directly proportional to the electrolytes present, and electrolytes basically increase the heating rates. Moisture content, as we all know that is the free water present within the material. So as moisture content thus act as an electrical conductor and heating the and increase the heating rates. Nature of food basically depends upon the electrolytic concentrations and moisture content. And last is the particle size. As the particle size increases, ohmic heating rates decreases because of increase in ohmic heating times. So the justification that ohmic heating, due to its rapid and uniform heating of food, it basically having high energy efficiency of more than 90%. So as process equipment industries design equipment according to the needs of large processing plants, so there is need to develop pilot scale ohmic heating heater units according to the needs of small and medium sized enterprises. So ohmic heating is basically run on the basis of electrical energy, and the cost of electric energy is the key parameter. So we need energy efficient ohmic heating system that can be run through solar energy. And also the local heating of plate is a big problem in ohmic heating, and very less work is done on the methods of reducing the local heating on plates. So the material and methods. So it generally includes ohmic reactor vessel of capacity 40 kg, 40 liters. Material of construction is stainless steel alloys. Outlet valve is of SS304. It is two-way type valve. Insulation chamber is outside the ohmic heating vessels. Generally, glass wool and thermoform is used for insulation. Electrodes are of titanium. And these electrodes are placed in a ohmic reactor vessels, and these are connected to power supply, and these electrodes make direct physical contact with the material which is to be heated. Volt control unit, so it is for the centralized control. It provides centralized control for all the electrical components used in a ohmic heating system. Voltage regulator, it basically provides the constant voltage throughout the run. Temperature and current data loggers for measurement of temperature and current. So previous work was done in NDRI, and the findings of the experiments were that heating rate was observed. So these are the parameters for 5 kg ohmic heating system. So heating rate was observed to be 3.5 degrees Celsius per minute, and the thermal efficiency of the system is more than 90%, and it can be improved by insulating the reactor vessel. And there is uniformity in heating with a very low temperature gradient, that is 0 to 1 degree Celsius. And on incorporation of agitator, no danger of falling was observed, or very little falling is observed on the plates. With agitator, local heating of plates was also reduced because of proper mixing and better distribution of heat. As ohmic heating, there is a requirement of large, ohmic heater basically requires large amount of current. So we use another approach, that is the variable area approach. But this approach further leads to more falling. So this approach doesn't give visible results to us. As agitator is incorporated on the front side of plate, the falling was reduced. But on the back side of the plates, falling due to forming, falling was there. So another approach, that drilling of plates was done for better performance of ohmic heating system. So by drilling holes into the plates, the current is distributed from front to back sides, and there is the optimization of CIP protocol for ohmic reactor system. So the objective of my research work is that to develop repeating field type ohmic heating system. As local heating is the problem in ohmic heating system, so my first objective is to develop rotating field type core for ohmic heating system. And according to the needs of small and medium sized processors, my second objective is to upscale the ohmic heating system to 40 kg capacity. So this is the design setup of ohmic heating system. Now, what are the factors I am am considering that fixed parameters, that milk, we are taking that is cow milk, temperature of milk, the initial milk is around 20 degrees Celsius, and final we have to heat up around 90 degrees Celsius, quantity of milk to be taken 40 liters, and the plate width is 3 to 5 mm, and the reactor vessel dimensions. Variable parameters include potential, electric potential, area of plates, gap between the plates,
Vishal, thank you so much.
And speed of agitator.
Please conclude.
So, measurable parameters are temperature profile, heating rate, heating time, current requirements, specific performance coefficient, which is the energy utilized for heating, or energy given to the sample, which is MCP delta D divided by PVIT. Electrical conductivity is was determined on the basis of resistance of the sample and the geometry of the cell. Power consumption we can calculate by PV, the P is equal to VIT, and thermal efficiency. So the summary is that the development of ohmic heating will be helpful for small and medium scale processing plants, and this study will help to generate engineering data which will be helpful for design of ohmic heater based on pilot scale unit, and use of solar energy to run ohmic heating system may result in energy economy.
Next speaker, Dhruvin Dev.
Good evening, one and all present here. Today I am going to present about the evaluation of various sensors for monitoring of quality changes in frying oil. The frying is one of the oldest and most popular practices of cooking, which is carried out by dipping food into 150 to 190 degrees centigrade for a couple of minutes. In 1973, first attempt was made to define the frying oil quality by a German Society of Fan Research. Fried involves most complex reaction which leads to formation of volatile and non-volatile compounds. Volatile compounds evaporated with vapor and non-volatile compounds remain within the oil. Now, there are three types of reaction: thermal alteration, hydrolysis and oxidation in deep fat frying, which leads to formation of trans fatty acid, triglycerides, glycerols, FFA and aldehydes and ketones, which are known as polar compounds. Now, rate of physical and chemical changes of oil during deep fat frying is constantly changing with the time. Here we can see that the fatty acid forming color viscosity polar material gradually increases with time, whereas total unsaturation decreases with time. And peroxides are initially increasing and then it is decreases. Now, frying oil quality is distributed in five groups. First is the break-in oil quality, which is initially, and then it converts to fresh and optimum oil quality. When it is start degrading, then it calls a degrading oil quality, and finally it is runaway oil quality. Runaway oil quality must be suggested to discard. Now, factors affecting the oil deterioration are the turnover rate, type of the fryer, intermittent heating and cooling, design and maintenance of the fryer, type of wood, light and use of filters. In India, FSSAI introduced the standard for the monitoring of quality, deep fat frying oil quality. They select the total polar compound as a criterion, which limit has set to be maximum 25%. And this regulation came into force from 1st July 2018. There are several health hazards reported in the literature, which causes heart attack, kidney failure, liver failure, etc. So, in India, every 30 seconds, 1% is killed by heart attack, and there is a major role of oil in the heart attacks. So some such methods and instruments are available, like food oil sensors, electronic nose, Testo 270, etc. Khalid and others developed capacity sensors. They basically use integrated electrodes, and this is based on capacitance. The variables they use are number of electrodes, width of the electrode, length of the electrode, and electrode space. They found that the total polar compounds are constantly increases, and with that capacitance also increases, and same for viscosity is also increasing. So they found regression value for total polar compounds is 0.83%, and for viscosity it is 0.79%. 2.79. Another one is electronic nose. In electronic noses, there are three types of sensors. They use the which having a special selectivity for moisture, pentane, and substance which is responsible for the odor. They first select the marker engineering. They select the marker substance which is responsible for the odor by using gas chromatography. They use a reference for wine quality checking the which is food oil sensor. And these three sensors are metal oxide sensors. And the minimum measuring time for the volatile vapors by electronic nose is 1 minute. So they found that the moisture is constantly fluctuating result which is present in the fat. And all metal oxide sensors are less or cost sensitive to the moisture. So sensor type 2 and sensor type 3 are destroyed at the time of experiment. So it is not desirable to implement a sensor for long term. Another one is Tester 270 cooking oil sensor, which is built on capacitance and also having a total polar compound measuring system. Red, there is a three colors indication. The red color indicate danger zone. In this zone, oil must be discarded. So some other authors also develop some methods or instruments, but having same drawbacks like fatty acid composition constantly changes, less working time, it is costlier, and the secondary products of oxidation, and such methods are required hazardous chemicals. So, my new instrument is needed to overcome that drawbacks. New instrument or methods needed for the industry. So, I am working with these two objectives, to measure various engineering and chemical properties during deep fat frying and to develop and evaluate various type of sensors for detecting changes in the oil quality. So research at NDI, I am at present measuring engineering organoleptic and chemical properties to identify the engineering marker which is which can interpret the frying oil quality. So after that the sensor will be developed. So future benefits are less chances of wrong interpretation, highlight change in cooking method prevailing in India and reduction of health hazard, and it leads to saving of life. Thank you.
All the IDA delegates present here. I am Lakshmana. I am pursuing Master in Dairy Engineering from NDRI Karnal. Today I am going to present on Udranati processing and its functional properties. India is the leading position in the milk production with a production of 165.4 million tons in the 2016-17 year. And with the production of used milk production in our India, there is a wide scope of the various milk and milk products. And also India contains a large vegetarian consumer compared to the non-vegetarians, so that the major population of vegetarian consumers mainly depend on dairy products for their protein-rich nutrients. And cheese is one of the most important products in the dairy world. Cheese contains a high level of proteins, which are rich source of essential amino acids. There are so many varieties of cheese produced in the different parts of the world. These are mainly classified into hard, semi-hard and soft cheeses based on their moisture content. And mozzarella cheese. Mozzarella cheese is one of the most famous cheese in the world. It accounts for almost one third of the total cheese consumption. It belongs to the family of pasta filata group, which is originated in the Battipaglia region of Italy. It is an unripened cheese and also a soft variety. It is mainly traditionally prepared from the raw buffalo milk. These are the processing factors and operations for the mozzarella cheese manufacture. Type of milk, standardization of milk, tea treatment, starter culture, pot light, cooking, stretching and molding. Type of milk. Mainly the cow or buffalo milk are used for the preparation of mozzarella cheese. Traditionally, the mozzarella cheese is prepared from the buffalo milk. The buffalo milk cheese produces high desirable properties compared to the cow milk because it contains a high percentage of fat and protein. It will produce a desirable quality cheese. And standardization of milk. Standardization of milk, in case of milk processing, we adjust the fat percentage in the milk. But for the preparation of cheese, we have to adjust the both fat and casein by maintaining the casein ratio to 0.7. For that, we are standardizing the fat by adding cumin and also the casein and retreatment of milk. Traditionally, the mozzarella cheese is prepared from buffalo, raw buffalo milk, but the shelf life of that cheese is very less. So, and also the producing the same product, you have to pasteurize the milk for the preparation of cheese. So, the pasteurization of milk is compulsory. That is, heating of the milk is 73 degrees Celsius for 15 seconds, and the scatter culture, STLV, are the two scatter culture mainly used for the preparation of mozzarella cheeses, and the coagulant. Coagulant is the mainly rennet. There are three types of rennet available, one from animal origin, plant origin, and microbial rennet. In our India, the more vegetarian consumers are there, they won't accept the rennet used from animal cheese. So that the more microbial rennet is used in the preparation of mozzarella cheese. And cooking. Cooking is the operation where the cooking of the curd is the way. It is a one step where we have to adjust the final moisture content in the mozzarella cheese. And stretching of the mozzarella cheese. Stretching is the process where we have to eat the curd 80 to 85 degrees Celsius for 2 to 3 minutes. It is the unique step in the mozzarella cheese preparation where it produces the desirable properties to the final product. And molding. Molding is the process for giving the desired final shape to the product by applying pressure and placing the cheese in the molds. There are two major methods in the preparation of mozzarella cheese. One is direct acidification method, another one is scatter culture method. The scatter culture method is traditionally used by using the scatter culture for the reduction of acidity in the milk. In the direct acidification method, the acids like hydrochloric acid, phosphoric acid, acetic acid, these acids are used for the reduction of the pH of milk while preparation of mozzarella cheese. I'll explain the project. This is the direct acidification method of mozzarella cheese manufacture. The milk is standard to get into fat ratio of 0.7 and then pasteurization, then cooling to 8 degrees Celsius. At 8 degrees Celsius, you have to reduce the pH of milk up to 5.2 and then it into 28 degrees Celsius for rennet addition. After rennet addition, you have to give time for settling. After settling, you have to cutting, then cooking, then wet draining. After wet draining, you have to move for stretching process. It is a unique process in the mozzarella cheese processing. That is the third mass is heated in a hot water of 80 to 85 degrees Celsius for 2 to 3 minutes. It will lead to the desirable changes in the structure of the curd and leads to desirable functional properties. And after the stretching process, we move for molding, then priming, and finally the packaging. And next method is the scatter culture method. It is similar to the direct acidification method, but only the difference is we reduce the pH of milk by addition of scatter culture. That is streptococcus thermophilus and lactococcus polygonicus with the 2% volume by 2% weight by volume basis. And then renetting, cutting, cooking, draining of milk, then pasteurizing, and the further process is similar to the direct acidification method. Then the functional properties of mozzarella cheese. What is functional property? Functional properties is the properties which are the properties of a product other than the nutritional properties. That is the properties behind the nutritional property, they are doing something by value addition. Like the cheese is also like a versatile product, it is used in various different products as an ingredient. For usage of a different product, it required some of the functional properties like stretchability, measurability, and some of the cheese. Suitability of cheese is a term which explains, it is a broad term which explains how the ease of machinability of the cheese and the structure integrity of the cheese and the suitability of the cheese is more in the cheese prepared from the buffalo milk than cow milk. The strength of having 3.2 mm of square cross section and the suitability will be more at the low temperature. If you shred at the temperature around 1 degree Celsius, it will give a very fine fine shred, and the shreddability is also value addition for the mozzarella cheese. Nowadays, the mozzarella cheese is also available in the market in the form of fresh shreds. And the meltability of the cheese. Meltability is a very important property of the mozzarella cheese that is mainly applicable in the preparation of fast foods like pizza, burger, and all. The meltability is the how the cheese melts after cooking. And the cheese must be melt uniformly throughout the surface of the pizza and all. And it is like in the shown in figure.
Lakshmana, your time is over.
And the factory is in the
city. The manpower of teaching faculty itself, everywhere, the especially have a very bright future and they have been managing for their teaching. I think you should be able to also have, once you have the flair for teaching, I encourage them to take the as a duck to the water and see that you gain all the necessary skills for the teaching jobs. Teaching, research and extension, they go together in the universities and the educational institutions.
There are my thoughts. Before I start the topic, I wanted to show a video which tells us, because now I will not show the video, it is not possible here, but the Apple CEO has made one comment that Indian graduates are not employable, because our teaching, education, research methodology hai, iske andar innovation as well as practical aspect are missing. This is the gist of that video, which was about 8 minutes video, and my basic presentation was on that only. Because I was working with an organization which was meant for imparting hands-on experience. Everyone knows that Vidyadhiri was established as a concept, because whatever we are teaching in the classroom, the industry wants that the graduates that are coming from the college should be in a position to operate the plants from day one. So with this genesis, I actually found out this video, which is very interesting. It is 7 to 8 minutes, because there they are telling that the kids in the school, they are not in a position to give their thoughts because they are in the hands of teachers and parents. And parents, students ka load इतना ज्यादा ले लेते हैं कि whenever they have any assignment, they hire the outside services. So that the thought process of the kid is not getting developed. So coming to the presentation now. Let's go to the presentation. Let's go to the presentation. Thank you. milk production side, if you see, there's a lot of efforts are being put in the enhancing the animal productivity enhancement. We at Amul Dairy have started a calf rearing station, wherein we are bringing calf from the producer, because mainly feeding properly is the problem. So we are rearing the calf, bringing it to the level that it is ready to become pregnant. Then we give it back to the producer, and whatever cost we are incurring, that is we are taking from the farmers, and they are getting the best quality animal. So this program we have started and is operating nicely. Now, reduction in the cost of milk production, that is always the agenda of the milk producer, because they want to earn more and more, and therefore providing cattle feed. And if animal loses one lactation, that means it is a lot of loss to the milk producer. So we have to see that it doesn't lose any lactation because of the proper breeding of the animal. Now, we at Amul, we are also providing this animal health and animal nutrition both, because we provide them cattle feed. We also provide them the veterinary services at the cheapest rate. And nowadays, lot of milk producers are taking this business of milk production as an entrepreneur, and they are developing their farm of 50-100 animals, and they are running it commercially viable unit. Now that coming to the milk processing and packing, you see that once the milk is collected, and from there we have to arrange the logistics and bring the milk at the lowest cost, transportation cost, to the dairy plant. Then at dairy the quality is assessed. Then the next point is that dairy equipment, starting from the selection of the equipment till the processing, it should be operated in an efficient manner. And the most and important part is the utility management, on which we have heard: refrigeration, boiler, what type of the techniques, VFD, then all other techniques. Everywhere we are installing VFD, or everywhere we are going for AM, everywhere we are going for flow meters in the dairy, so that we can control and monitor our processes properly. And water is going to be the main headache in the coming one or another 10 years. And the biggest another headache is that we are developing plants, but we are not developing our ATP properly. And that is our liability to maintain the environment, because that is also environment, safety, food safety, all energy conservation. These are the buzzwords in today, and we have to work on that. Now, value addition is the only source. It serves two things. One is it increases your profit, and another thing that it satisfies the consumer. So I am not really telling much on that. Once the products are made, then you should have a adequate go down and cold storage. Yesterday, I think some discussion was going on that how best we can efficiently manage the cold store. Now there is a ARSV system is also developed, wherein the products are taken from the production area to the cold store automatically, and when you have to dispatch, then also it is coming out. We have installed two such cold storages in Amul Dairy Anand. Then distribution logistics is the main thing. For that we have a marketing body, Gujarat Agri Milk Marketing Federation, and they have their own way of distribution, and that's the only way to win over the industry. Now these are the four things on which the dairy industry rotates. One is the food safety work, that is our commitment. Another is the cost reduction, that comes through optimized resource utilization. And the fourth liability on us is the environment protection. Now, if we see that hands-on experience is an essential part in dairy technology education, whether we agree or disagree. The reason is that what we teach in the college is the knowledge. And knowledge can only be converted into skills if you have appropriate hands-on experience. We have a lot of ITIs working in our dairy. So when a dairy technologist or dairy engineer go to his first job, he is being examined by his subordinates. This aapko kitna aata hai? और सांप को कितना आता है, वो एक बार घुमा देगा, सांप को पता है कि नहीं, वो एग्जाम ले लेता है, बिकॉज सांप ने कभी बाल घुमाए नहीं है, इसलिए ये परिस्थिति होती है। तो स्टूडेंट्स जब जाते हैं इंडस्ट्री एनवायरनमेंट में, तो इंडस्ट्री की रिक्वायरमेंट है कि हमको रेडीमेड मटेरियल दे दो जो प्लांट ऑपरेट करते हैं, और प्लांट एनवायरनमेंट जो है उसके अंदर स्किल्स की रिक्वायरमेंट। तो जब तक ये हैंड ऑन एक्सपीरियंस नहीं होगा तब तक उसके अंदर स्किल डेवलप नहीं होगी, अगर स्किल नहीं होगी तो उसका इंडस्ट्री के अंदर सर्वाइवल का थोड़ा प्रॉब्लम हो सकता है। अब इफ यू गो टू द टिपिकल एजुकेशन इंस्टीट्यूट, देन यूनिवर्सिटी और ICAR की जो फ्रेमवर्क है उसके अंदर ही ऑपरेट करना है। मतलब एजुकेशन, एग्रीकल्चर एजुकेशन इज अ स्टेट सब्जेक्ट, तो स्टेट कैन डिसाइड द पॉलिसी, सो देयर कैन नॉट बी ए जनरल पॉलिसी एज फॉर द एडमिशन ऑफ द स्टूडेंट इज कंसर्न, फैकल्टी इंडक्शन इज कंसर्न और इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर इज कंसर्न। सो अभी साहब बता रहे थे 20-22 कॉलेज हो गई है, तो इसका कारण ये है कि हर एक के अंदर इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर प्रॉपर नहीं है, तो देन यू कैनॉट हैव द यूनिफॉर्म स्किल्स इन द स्टूडेंट्स। और स्टूडेंट्स के लिए भी ऐसा है, स्टूडेंट्स को कम पढ़ना है, फैकल्टी जो है उसकी जो, अब जब हम करिकुलम फॉर्म करते हैं यूनिवर्सिटी लेवल में तो उसके अंदर सारे कॉम्पोनेंट ले लेते हैं, बेसिक भी आना चाहिए, लेटेस्ट भी आना चाहिए, तो स्टूडेंट्स क्या करेगा? और उसके लिए हमने इनोवेशन या तो प्रैक्टिकल का तो स्कोप धीरे धीरे कम होता जा रहा। अभी कुछ दिन पहले आनंद में मीटिंग थी PG के बारे में, मैंने उनको इतना ही बताया कि आप कोर्स एड करते हो, आप मिनिमम क्रेडिट का रखते हो, लेकिन मैक्सिमम क्रेडिट का कोई क्राइटेरिया है? बिकॉज मेनी गाइड्स आर गिविंग 90 credits, लेकिन फिर भी हम अपने कोई चूकना नहीं चाहिए, ऐसी हम अपनी सिस्टम बना रहे हैं। और फैकल्टी के पास क्या फ्रीडम है बताऊंगा, उसको सेमेस्टर लीव भी हम नहीं देते, उसको अपग्रेड करने का भी चांस नहीं देते। एडमिशन के अंदर लोकल 80% स्टूडेंट होने चाहिए। जब हम पढ़ते थे तब आसाम से भी आते, पंजाब से भी हमारे सामने बैठे हमारे स्टूडेंट्स, दे आर कमिंग थ्रू ICAR एंड दे आर गोइंग अवर एम्बेसडर्स टू वेरियस स्टेट्स, बट दोस थिंग्स वी आर फीलिंग एंड देन वी आर आस्किंग, द चैलेंजेस आर दिस, व्हाट वी वांट टू से दैट वी आर एक्चुअली कलेक्टिवली मेकिंग द एजुकेशन सिस्टम सो कॉम्प्लेक्स। अच्छा, इवेल्युएशन के अंदर आप देखोगे ऑनलाइन एग्जामिनेशन, ऑनलाइन रिपोर्ट सबमिशन अभी नहीं कर रहे हम, विद्या देवी में ऑनलाइन रिपोर्ट का कर दिया, स्टूडेंट के पास से क्या एक्सपेक्टेशन है, वो उसका ऑनलाइन में एवरीडे हैज टू गो एंड इट विल गो टू द ट्रेनिंग टीचर टू द कॉलेज, सो लाइक दैट वी हैव टू मेक देयर वर्क ऑफ इजी, देन द स्टूडेंट्स विल टेक इंटरेस्ट। अब ये रिसर्च की बात है, मैं दो इंसिडेंट इसके बारे में कहना चाहूंगा। हमारे यहाँ जो रिसर्च होती है वो गाइड के एरिया में लेनी पड़ती है, स्टूडेंट्स के पास कोई चॉइस नहीं है कि इंडस्ट्री की क्या रिक्वायरमेंट्स है। मैं टिपिकल एग्जांपल मेरा ही बता रहा हूँ कि जब मैंने को PhD का एडमिशन लेने का था तो आई हैड वर्क ऑन सेकंड इन एमएससी, सो नेचुरली आई वुड लाइक टू वर्क ऑन द इंडिजिनियस प्रोडक्ट। तो मुझे ऐसा बोला गया कि अगर तुम मुझे गाइड रखोगे तो तुम्हारा काम जल्दी हो जाएगा। इंटरव्यू में मुझे क्वेश्चन पूछा गया सिलेक्शन में कि whom you would like to have your guide, I told them that sir I have come to earn my PhD degree in India right now, I am a teacher, I want to go back in 3 years to my college, now whosoever you want to give as a guide I have prepared, but with the grace of the world I could complete my PhD in 3 years, exactly 3 years। बट कई लोगों को 4 साल लग जाते, 4.5 साल लग सकते, क्यों? तो अप टू गाइड के स्टैंडर्ड का काम नहीं हुआ है। इस मुझे 80% मेरा काम होने के बाद ऐसा बोला गया था कि आपको दूसरा रिसर्च प्रोजेक्ट हम देंगे। मैंने बोला भाई बोलते हैं द वर्क इज नॉट अप टू द स्टैंडर्ड, देन आई रेज ओनली 1 पॉइंट टू द डायरेक्टर ऑफ इंडिया राइट, दैट सर मेरा जो ये प्रोजेक्ट है वो एडवाइजरी कमिटी के सामने प्रेजेंटेशन किया था, उसमें मैंने प्लान ऑफ वर्क लिखा था,
और उसके अंदर मुझे एक ऋण दिया है, अब आप 3 साल के बाद मुझे ऐसा करें आपको नया लेना पड़ेगा, तो फिर स्टूडेंट्स की क्या हाल होगी। तो ये जो पीजी एजुकेशन के अंदर है, इस तरीके की कुछ चीजें हैं जिसको हम निकालना चाहिए, जैसा मेरा शरीर चैलेंज है। दूसरी चीज मैं आपको बता रहा हूँ कि somebody from the industry asked me at Vidya Devi कि तुम टीचर लोग है ना आउट ऑफ द बॉक्स कभी सोचते ही नहीं हो, सो मेनी थिंग्स आर रिलेटेड इन अदर इंडस्ट्रीज बट हम तो अपनी डेयरी इंडस्ट्री में कन्फाइन है। मुझे ये पूछा कि जलेबी जो है ऐसी क्यों है, तुम सीधी जलेबी बना सकते हो? मैंने बोला था वो कैसे, वो जलेबी नहीं देगी। बोलता है कि स्टील इंडस्ट्री के अंदर आयरन जो है वो स्ट्रेट करके वो निकालते, तो अगर हम डेयरी इंडस्ट्री में वो टेक्नोलॉजी करके जलेबी को तो फायर में से निकाल करके चाशनी में होकर सीधा स्टिक्स के फॉर्म में जैसे हमको निकाल सकते। बोलते हैं आप लोगों के बस की बात नहीं है, एट दैट टाइम आई वाज अ टीचर एंड द विद्या देवी। सिमिलरली एक टिपिकल दूसरा एग्जांपल आपको देना चाहता हूं कि बाय अडॉप्टिंग सर्टेन ऑपरेशंस हमने श्रीखंड जो है सुगम श्रीखंड जो बनाया, एक्चुअली वो उस सेट ऑफ द इक्विपमेंट को सीरीज में रख के बनाया है। क्वार्क सेंटर में हम मस्का बनाएंगे, उसके बाद ग्राइंडर मिक्सर में शुगर डालेंगे, फिर उसको हीट करेंगे और उसके बाद उसको एसेप्टिकली पैक करेंगे। तो आज के दिन में पूरी परिभाषा, तो इंडस्ट्री ये चाहती है कि हमारे रिलेवेंस काम को स्टूडेंट्स भी पेपर ये चाहता है, लेकिन इंडस्ट्री और एकेडमिक इंस्टीट्यूशन का इंटरेक्शन ठीक नहीं होने की वजह से, कहीं ना कहीं ईगो का क्लैश होने की वजह से हमारे ये हाल चल रहा है। तो हमको गुड प्रोफेसर करने हैं, इसके लिए हम हैं, और उसके लिए क्या स्किल चाहिए, और ये स्किल है वो आपको इंडस्ट्रियल एनवायरमेंट्स में ही मिलती है, चाहे वो लीडरशिप हो, इनोवेशन हो, प्रॉब्लम सॉल्विंग हो, पर्सनल हो, या तो ह्यूमन रिसोर्स स्टैट्यूटरी का नॉलेज है। जब विद्या डेयरी के अंदर कोई स्टूडेंट आता है तो देयर आर 12 मॉड्यूल्स, ही हैज टू गो टू द डेयरी बिजनेस, नॉट ओनली डेयरी टेक्नोलॉजी, डेयरी इंजीनियरिंग, सो ही विल गो टू द फाइनेंस अकाउंट आल्सो टू लर्न हाउ टू रीड द बैलेंस शीट, ही विल आल्सो गो टू द मार्केट एंड सी दैट व्हाट कंज्यूमर वांट्स, कितने टाइम में वो लोग क्या करते हैं। वी हैव वन रिटेल शॉप दैट द स्टूडेंट्स हैज टू वर्क, तो वहां उसको पैसे गिनने पड़ते हैं, पैसे जोड़ने पड़ते हैं, और एक दिन के अंदर 1000 मिनिमम कस्टमर आते हैं, तो उसका टेम्परामेंट कैसे होता है, उसे बात कैसे करने का, तो उसकी ओवरऑल पर्सनलिटी डेवलप होती है, उसका ऑटोमेशन का भी मॉड्यूल है, क्वालिटी कंट्रोल का भी है। तो मैंने लास्ट टाइम भी वहाँ एनडीआर करनाल में भी ऐसा बोला था कि अच्छी चीज़ों को छोड़ के हम नई चीज़ डालने की कोशिश कर रहे हैं और हमारा जो एक्सलेंस है उसको नीचे ले जा रहे हैं। अगर विद्या देवी का कंसेप्ट सक्सेसफुल है, सैंडविच के तौर में उसको टर्मिनल ले गए 1 साल की जगह 6 महीने का, अब बोलते हैं सारी कॉलेज में विद्या देवी नहीं हो सकते, इसलिए हमको तो इंडस्ट्री में भेजना पड़ेगा। इंडस्ट्री में कोई सिखाता नहीं है, स्टूडेंट को भी सीखना नहीं होता, बिकॉज 1979 में व्हेन आई वाज अ स्टूडेंट आई यूज्ड टू एंटर फ्रॉम वन गेट ऑफ अमूल एंड कमिंग आउट ऑफ सेकंड बिकॉज नोबडी वाज लुकिंग एट अस। तो अगर आप एजुकेशन में रियल जो चैलेंजिंग एरिया है वो मैंने हाईलाइट किए, आई थिंक दैट्स ऑल व्हाट आई वांटेड टू टेल दैट आपको हमको अच्छा एजुकेशन सिस्टम बनाना है, तो वर्क ऑन हाउ बेस्ट
Thank you very much, Desai sir. Many things, and sorry for the issues in the presentation and technical issues. But back to talk, and you could admirably handle the issues. Thank you very much for the nice presentation, and very crucial things you have talked, and one of the touching things is the first test, the crucial test is by your workers and subordinates in the dairy plant. Saapko kuch aata hai kya? This is one of the most terrorizing statement I tell to my students. You are going to be judged by your operator first, not these exams and not these things. That's one of the crucial tests of the things. I thank very much, and any questions of the education thing, interaction if it is there, I'm welcome. I hope our chairman find any comments.
Good morning, friends. First of all, I want to congratulate Shri S. Agarwal passed successfully, and Ms. Yagarwalji and the entire team passed successfully organizing this seminar. I am very much delighted to be in the city Indore, the clean city of India. It is my privilege and pleasure to be part of this seminar. I am Vishwamitra, basically a retired general manager from Punjab district.
Listen to all of you. It is my great privilege to come in this seminar. It is first for me in India. And since Dr. Sani invited me, and I regard him too much, since I joined the NDRI Kangali in 1995. So I could not say him no, and it is my great privilege. And I feel it to come back to my home. See, the first job is just like an institution from where you have graduated. So it was the first job in NDRI as a daily engineer or process engineer, whatever you say. It was a real challenge for me in the beginning because of very few courses in undergraduate and postgraduate I had studied. In daily engineering and daily technology related courses. But when I joined, then I thought that now there is no way and I have to work on that. And the first and the most important project which we had taken, that was the ball making machine from China, which was later commercialized or licensed to Amul. And also we wanted to prove that we can, engineering scientists can also develop a product. And sometimes I would to say that better than the food technologies and others. And the first product I have developed there is the instant makhana kheer mix. And that makhana kheer mix is now as a product patent. You know, there is a difference between process patent and product patent. If I have the product patent, no one can manufacture that product by changing anything. They have only way to take the license. So there are 3-4 licenses of that product now. So that was a brief introduction for my work. And after going to Proms, NDRI, I went to CBEM. And still I am working on MIL. I had a mega project of 4 crore rupees from ICR on detection of adulterants, all kind of adulterants and toxics in the milk and fruit juices. So a lot of publications I have on the MIL. My usual habit is that whatever subject I choose, I never leave that. Always continuity should be maintained. The topic given by Dr. Sani and the association was the challenges. Though I feel that I am very small boy for telling you the challenges in the research and education in daily engineering and or technology or processing. Because you see, the industry, you have already said that industry is the main person who can say that practically what are the challenges. But in education challenges, whatever I have written, I have only few slides, only 7-8, and I have enumerated based on my own experience. And not copied it from anywhere. And I have had those experiences. And first challenge I see, as a daily engineering, the challenge is the idea itself. As you have said yesterday that very few people come and attend, numbers are very less. So somehow we have to increase the number of daily engineers or daily processors at educational level. Would you have the daily engineering post-graduation in master course and PhD in many places, but there is no undergraduation. यदि आधार ही नहीं है तो बिना आधार का पेड़ कैसे कितना बड़ा होगा दैट इज वेरी वेरी इजीली यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड थिंक ऑन दैट हाउ वी कैन गो फॉर डेली इंजीनियरिंग बीटेक और कैन इट बी मर्ज्ड विद डेली टेक्नोलॉजी एंड ओनली डेली इंजीनियरिंग एंड टेक्नोलॉजी डिग्री शुड बी देयर बट इन दैट केस बोथ बोथ स्ट्रीम पीपल शुड हैव कम टुगेदर and then they have to divide the new course. What I have felt that once you do the, you don't do the BTech course in engineering, there are so many basic engineering courses that is lacking. That is lacking in a master and PhD level. And when you need the core design of certain equipment, machining with a single part, that may not become perfect. And as usual, we are the habitual to make the machine perfect by hit and trial. Hit and trial. Usually, we make the machine and then we do the drawing later on. But that is not the actual design process. Design process that you should be first convinced that this is the parameters which is final, and this parameter should be met by this amount of dimensions of this particular particles or particular parts of a machine. And design should be once and fabricated, then one or two or three trials should be more than sufficient for making the final adjustment in the machine. But that is lacking. So in this slide, I would like, my topic is a little different. Some words you may not like, some you may like it. But you see, most of you are only convinced by doing further processing and milk productions. No one is thinking for how to sustain that. We pat our back that we are number one in the milk production, always. We are going to be number one in population. Many think number two we are. But how long will we be number two or number one? Our population is increasing continuously. Already you are getting the milk production at 165 or 17 million metric ton. How long this rate of increment will sustain? That you have to think. So demand will increase because population is increasing, life expectancy is increasing, so population will increase, demand will go on increasing. There will be a time that you will be needing 5,000 million metric ton, then maybe 10,000 million metric ton requirement in 50 years. So how you are going to sustain that? So we have to think for production of milk. So my topic is mainly based on how to sustain the supply of milk for the population which you are going to increase. So research challenges. So another important point I have underlined is income oriented, not the production oriented. Present agriculture was each still only production oriented. So many men, metric ton, million tons, this, that. No one think after production. It should be income oriented. I had come to know a few days back, a few months back maybe, that in some part of Gujarat that milk production is so high and market demand is less. So cost farmer is not getting. So I do not know whether this news was correct or wrong, but we have to devise the system to be income centric, income oriented, then only farmers can contribute with a happy mind, with a happy health, and their country will be very happy. And not production centric. Production centric agriculture and animal husbandry should be avoided. Income oriented is better. Topic itself in case. So I have divided this into two parts, production, dairy production, dairy engineering in dairy production, and dairy engineering in dairy processing. Dairy farming, that is milk production. Meat production also in dairy farming, but livestock product technology, but I have not kept here. Our aim should be maximizing output per unit input. Can anyone of you tell that what is the cost of milk production? Production cost per liter? Production cost of milk, as I have come to know, that around 16 to 20 rupees per liter, depending upon the breeds and cow or cattle. And so a farmer is selling in 25 rupees or 20 rupees. I don't think that they are getting sufficient amount for their livelihood. It is just their support not livelihood, not a main occupation. So we should devise, we should come with a methodology or system which minimize the production of the milk from the animal. On that, scientists, engineers should think on. Then animal feed. Now question is safe feed also. Whatever you have, you give to your animal, farmer give to the animal for feeding, and some diseases come and veterinary doctors are not in sufficient number, and farmer gets sick, and that milk produced by that farmer come to the human beings. So, and I have also come to know that some of the feeds also contain aflatoxins because of the high moisture and fatty husk or some of the straw and other things. So, safe food feed for the animals, then primary processed high value products from the low value, high volume product, byproducts of the dairy industry. For example, a of whey, maybe the urine, maybe the cow dung. These are the byproducts of the dairy. And there are so many research activities have been conducted for better utilization and for getting the high value product from the commodity. And no dairy engineers, processing engineers are working on this. As of now, I have come to know. So we should focus on that, except the biogas system we have developed based on this commodity or nothing else. Some whey protein, something are there, but not much in commercialized state. Then animal housing, some are. Sporadic work has been conducted on the animal housing in the last, you can say, 15-20 years back, and very little work has been conducted. I have personal experience in Sivak, Ludhiana. There were 2-3 projects with Gadwasu, Ludhiana. Just downing the temperature in May, April, May by 10-15 degrees Celsius, 20-25% of milk production increased. So environment control for the animals which producing the milk is very important, and on that we should do more and more work. Micro level animal housing and animal handling. See, no one think much about how to care, how to handle the animals. That is very important. Particularly in the sick time, they are handling very badly. Some of the equipment machines are being imported from outside. For example, lifting devices. Some devices have been developed by CIE Bhopal and also by Sivak Ludhiana. Those things should be tried. And micro environment. Anyone of you have thought of any time for a shirt or a cumble, blankets or any kind of cloth for an animal? In village, I have seen the winter, our father, mother used to put some salt, old salts and other things to the, particularly to the bullock, not to the cow and the fallow. So they also feel the same things. If they are not happy, usually we say that the milk production is very less in the winter. Milk production is more in the rainy season. Because more greens, comfortable weather, less temperature, accommodatable, relative humidity, and severe winter milk production is less. So how you can think that the cow or buffalo is in the severe cold and she can produce milk more and more for you? Never it can. So I think no one has tried to design a cloth which may be comfortable for a cow or buffalo for winter or for summer. For ourselves, there are so many designers, fashion design, technology has come. What is about the cow and buffalo, on which you are dependent? No one has thought of. Think on that. It becomes very hard. No solution has come. And if some solution has come, that is little known, not being practiced at mass scale. So traditional products require mechanization at a small level. All halwa, all mithai shops should have a small machine. और हाथ का काम खत्म होना चाहिए. कोई दिन के बाद कोई खेती नहीं करेगा, कोई गाय नहीं चराएगा, कोई दूध से मिल्क नहीं बनाएगा. मिल्क से कोई किसी का बच्चा करना नहीं चाहता, मजबूरी में करता है. सब लोग कंपनी खोलना चाहता है और फॉर कंपनी ओनली मशीन आल्सो शुड बी इक्विप्ड विद आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस. आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस जो जिसको आप बता दो जो हमने मिल्क दिया है, मुझे इससे पनीर चाहिए या खोआ चाहिए या रसगुल्ला चाहिए, एंड दैट मशीन शुड प्रोड्यूस इट. सो स्मॉल मशीन शुड बी डेवलप्ड फॉर दैट. टेबल टॉप स्वीट पनीर मेकिंग मशीन. मिनिमाइजेशन ऑफ वाटर. इसी आपको मालूम है कि 2050 तक हमें पानी पीने के लिए भी नहीं रहेगा. 2025 के बाद हम पानी स्कार्सिटी में चले जाएंगे. इंडिया विल गो इन द स्कार्सिटी ऑफ in the country list of where water will be the scarce commodity. There will be less water for production of agriculture produce, there will be less water for processing and energy. And dairy is highly water sensitive. So I think all process should be developed using the pneumatic systems only. Cleaning should be avoided using the water as much as possible. I do not know why not it is possible. We should try. And I challenge all the scientists that they can come any time to me for discussion of research of any kind of thing. I am free for discussion for any idea. You see, your idea should have a real idea. And then you will have the real idea, then people will come with another new idea. Because it should be a chain of idea. And you are successful of your idea on 50%. Not forever on that. You see, if you type Essentia on Google and you will find my name on first page, in second or first place, then I become very happy that I have contributed a lot in the literature. That's why my name is coming there. I have contributed a lot to the industry. That's why my name is coming to the food processing industry. So you do something to become Amar Ajar. Scientist's job is a very important job, the best job. You see, marne ke baad sabko bhul jata hai. Wo the big leaders are forgotten. Kuch bhi bada se bada award aapko mil jayega. Aapko kisi ko nahi pata hoga jo Padma Bhushan, Padma Bhushan, Bharat Ratna, paanch ka naam puchhe to immediately koi nahi batayega. So no one will know. Only your family will know you forever.
Diseases, HIV, epidemiology, infectious diseases, malaria, dengue, kalazar, filaria. So I am going to speak today about some of the problems that you all people must be facing in your daily lives. It is an outreach program that ICMAR does for some of these exhibitions where we put up a stall. I don't know how many people have visited this stall where we are putting our activities that we pursue in ICMAR. First of all, just let me tell you that you need to be careful about four things in your daily routine. Less of salt, less of sugar, less of trans fats, and no palm oil to be used in your diets. As you know, when we have done a global disease burden in India, we find that anybody can guess which is the disease on the topmost which our country is facing today. Any guess? Anybody can guess? It is, yes please. It is on second position. So the first position is mental disorders. Psychiatric problems, neurodegenerative diseases, Alzheimer's, Parkinson, I mean these are the diseases that are on the top. Aapne kabhi dekha hoga ki aapke parents, grandparents, they are not able to sleep the whole night, which is called as chronic sleep apnea. वो क्यों है ऐसे कि क्यों वो लोग बेचारे सारी रात नहीं सो सकते और सुबह जब होता है तो दे फील सो लेथार्जिक एंड सो डिस्टर्ब्ड दैट दे कुड नॉट स्लीप द होल नाइट एंड यू मस्ट बी नोइंग दैट सम ऑफ दीस पीपल दे वॉक इन द नाइट ओपन द रेफ्रिजरेटर ईट एवरीथिंग ईट पूरा पूरा पसीना भी खाना दूध का पी जाते हैं पर उनको सुबह कुछ नहीं याद रहता and we are facing such kind of problems with very old people and this is the major problem of the country and mental disorders are now on the top. Followed by this is the cardiovascular diseases, hypertension. सब लोग इतना इतना नमक खा रहे हैं जिंदगी में इतना इतना नमक खाते हैं हम कहते हैं कि मुट्ठी भर नमक से चुटकी भर नमक पे आ गए लो सोडियम सॉल्ट शुड बी टेकन एज यू ईट लॉट ऑफ सॉल्ट देयर इज लॉट ऑफ वाटर रिटेंशन इन योर बॉडी एंड द बॉडी ब्लोट्स अप उससे क्या होता है ब्लड प्रेशर गोज अप person becomes hypertensive and there is a chance for getting either a heart attack or a stroke or similar problems related to the heart. Now what is happening is that namak jo hota hai usko aapki matra jo hai usko ghatana hi padega aapko diet mein. Aajkal sab bachche kya kar rahe hain bahut sara junk food khate hain chahe wo samosa ho pizza ho burgers ho momos ho pasta ho sab kuch isme itna namak hai ki jab ye bachche ye log khate hain तो है नहीं ये बच्चे आप कितना भी कह लो कि हमारे घर का खाना हुआ खाया करो वो वहां पे अपना खाना रख लेते हैं कैंटीन से ऑल दिस जंक फूड इज ईटन एज अ रिजल्ट यू आर कंज्यूमिंग लॉट ऑफ सॉल्ट एंड देन लॉट ऑफ वाटर इज एंड इट इज वेरी डिफिकल्ट फॉर सच चिल्ड्रन टू रिड्यूस देयर वेट सो दिस इज द फर्स्ट प्रॉब्लम नाउ द थर्ड डिजीज दैट आवर कंट्री इज डायबिटीज एज यू नो बाय 2025 इंडिया इज गोइंग टू बिकम द कैपिटल ऑफ डायबिटीज एंड एट प्रेजेंट देयर आर 70% ऑफ पीपल हु आर ऑन द प्री डायबिटिक स्टेज आप लोग चेक नहीं कराते दैट्स अनदर इशू बट इफ एनीबॉडी गोस एंड गेट्स हिमसेल्फ फॉर शुगर टेस्टेड देयर आर अबाउट 70% ऑफ पीपल हु आर ऑन द प्री डायबिटिक स्टेज एंड दे वुड बी सून कन्वर्टिंग देमसेल्फ इनटू अ डायबिटिक पेशेंट उसके लिए आपको क्या करना है उसके लिए आपको लेस ऑफ शुगर करना ही पड़ेगा और फ्री शुगर अभी नेक्स्ट स्पीकर माय प्रीवियस स्पीकर वाज स्पीकिंग ऑन अ मिल्क कंजम्पशन एंड लो शुगर कंटेंट नाउ वी सजेस्ट एज डॉक्टर्स वी आर टेलिंग पीपल टू कंज्यूम only 250 ml of milk per day. It may be either in the form of paneer or it will be form of a chaach or dahi or milk or whatever. Because now he is saying that we are trying to make sugarless milk because milk contains lot of sugar. So milk quantity also has to be restricted while the patient is on diabetes. And the second thing is that wheat. आप लोग कहते हैं हम कुछ खाते ही नहीं हैं हम तो एक ही रोटी खाते हैं पूरे दिन में हमने कुछ खाया ही नहीं है फिर हमारा शुगर लेवल क्यों नहीं कम हो रहा आपको पता है वीट में भी इतना ग्लूटेन होता है दैट सो शुगरी दैट इट हैज लॉट ऑफ शुगर इन इट तभी हम सजेस्ट करते हैं कि वीट में आपको आटा सोयाबीन मिलाइए बेसन मिलाइए एनीथिंग दैट्स अ मिसा आटा सो दैट आटा शुड बी कंज्यूम दैट वे एंड नॉट बाय ईटिंग जस्ट वीट बिकॉज वीट ऑल्सो हैज लॉट ऑफ शुगर सो देयर आर डाइट रिस्ट्रिक्शंस इफ यू कम टू आवर स्टॉल द नेशनल इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ न्यूट्रिशन अंडर आईसीएमआर गिव मी गाइडलाइंस फॉर सच पीपल फॉर आवर डायबिटीज and jinka HbA1c bilkul bhi kam nahi hota 3 months 4 months even if you are taking metformin or even you are taking dalbutrin or any combination of any drugs still your sugar level does not come down and on your diet restriction but we will tell you how to focus on such things which will help reduce your sugar so uske baad yes I don't know Indore is a beautiful place I have found it that there is no pollution here but when you come back to Delhi it's a highly polluted city and the environmental factors are adding to the lung diseases. That is coming on the fourth scenario after diabetes and people are suffering from a lot of, adding to this is smoking also and so the lung disease is on the rise. And then finally on the fifth disease is the maternal and child health and infectious diseases are coming down because we are trying to develop vaccines for them and so that infectious diseases like malaria, dengue, tularemia, Japanese encephalitis, Gorakhpur, 300 children die, almost 300 to 600 children die every year. You may be giving any excuse for their death, but it is the Japanese encephalitis, the virus that is the mosquito that bites children when they are playing around the bushes. And this virus is so deadly that it goes into the brain and it affects the organs instantaneously and there is an organ failure and the children die. Cancer is also coming down because at the first stage, if you are able to recognize the cancer can be curable. Of course, with chemotherapy and other paraphernalia with cancers. And cancer, of course, if you are, we have devised technology, the Magna Visualizer. And this Magna Visualizer is one machine which can be used by even ASHA workers in a small village. they can detect cancers, and the patient then is then transferred to bigger institutions if he's on the second or third stage of cancer. So this institute is being commercialized, and the industry is being involved to upgrade the technology and pass it on to the remote villages where cancer can be done. And we are also giving gifts to women for breast cancer, and of course cervical cancer. And these are the, anybody knows which is the cancer which is the most killing cancer of the country. It is not the blood cancer, or it is not this thing. Pancreatic cancer is one cancer which is very, very difficult, and the person normally dies after this cancer. So for that also, we are restricting your diet. Red meat should be avoided, and we always tell people that red meat should be avoided to the maximum if you want to, you know, have precautions against cancer. Then we are also doing research on the herbal medicines, since our Prime Minister is very keen that India has a rich biodiversity of so many herbs, and there are so many herbal ingredients in the plants which are which can be used for refractory diseases where modern medicine does not seem to have a good cure. And for this, ICMR is driving into various research projects on herbs which can be revalidated. I mean, without validation, and you just say that our ancestors use this and this, nobody is going to believe that unless there is a scientific validation of these drugs, and then they are converted into some kind of products or processes. And we have come with a notification, even now the herbal drugs can be taken forward through the DCGI route in the similar way as modern medicines can be done. And therefore we are trying to make drugs out of plants. We are doing researches, advanced stage of research, and for cancers, for children epilepsy, for pre-diabetes, that is the major problem for the country, and we have got very good results in our projects, just waiting for the technology to be transferred, and so that you can get a drug which is, you can say you can maintain your diabetes, if it is not better than metformin, but it is equivalent that you maintain your health and your diabetes will be maintained. So for maintenance, as an additional or a drug with a modern drug without any herb drug interaction, trying to develop certain herbal products so that it would be benefited for the health of this country. Now when we come to the mobile phones, I mean, I would like to speak on some aspects of mobile phones. Children nowadays are always on the mobile phones, and mobile phones radiations are supposed to be very hazardous, not only for the person who is holding the mobile phone in his hand, but also small children who are very close to this, because these radiations affect the brain of the child, and it is very difficult for the child to develop his or her brain. So this is another aspect that ICMR is working on. And of course, besides all this, ICMR is working on the myocardiovascular. Our DG, the present DG, is a leading cardiologist of the country, Dr. Balram Bhargav. He is a practicing leading academician at the All India Institute of Medical Sciences, New Delhi, and has developed stents that are cheaper, that would be affordable, that would be affordable for the poor. As you know, there are a lot of blockages arteries, and the stents is the easier way to open your arteries, and these are affordable equipments which anybody can buy now at the All India Institute of Medicine, AIIMS, New Delhi, and there is a chance for these stents.
Sometimes we have a new product or new food and all that, we go and stand at the final arbiter of the health, that is ICMR. Sometimes we grudge this product is not making the ICMR is wasting time, not preparing exactly those products, that was the case. But all of audience, I personally on message that is there about the cell phones, very can have speech defects because of the cell phones. The madam was saying keep it away from children. I want the children to keep it away from the adults, because they watch us and they get these things. So I was surprised that NIMHANS, the mental health organization in Bangalore, has a separate ward for his cell phone, what is it called? Blue screen defects. That is cell phone, laptop, TV. These come as a modern tool, but it is a very dangerous tool. And telling the personal tragic experience that I am saying, I'm paying to my nose to rectify the speech defects of my grandson. Please keep away cell phones. Okay, we come to the end of this session. I thank Desai, who attended, and Dr. Profusely thank Dr. Asim Jha. It's a pleasure for me to sit in this classroom once again in almost a 45 minutes lecture. But I don't think, even though I'm afraid of him, and, because of the surprise test, he will give us and keep us on the toes. And I also thank Mr. Tanin Madhukar for the.
Thank you, sir. I request Engineer S. Agarwal, President Idea, to please give the welcome address.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. It's my privilege to we have already welcomed him, but formally I welcome Dr. Asim Jha as Chief Guest of our faculty session. Sir was telling that now we are in the last phase of the conference, and I do hope that, so it was very, very, although we are very small in numbers, but it was a very good technical session yesterday, and everybody was so absorbed. Somebody has commented that jitna kam hota hai utna achcha hota hai, small is gold. Yeah, everybody was very attentive in this thing. So, just not taking much time. Sir, Indian Dairy Engineering Association was formed in April 2002 with the sole purpose to share the knowledge among ourselves. And I have seen, sir, your love for the sharing of information, because you are the chief guest of today's function, but still you agreed to be the honorable speaker in the session. And your thoughts are very informative and what we call that revolutionary in the sense. You have told that the production is a topic of the day, hot topic of the day, production or income. Farmer is, milk producer is confused between the two. He is confused between the two whether the production has to be higher or income has to be higher. Because if we produce more, the prices are reduced. If we produce less, probably you get the better prices. So no compromise, nobody among us has done any work on this direction as to what to do. It's a $1 million question, and we hope that a person like you at the helm of care, who is provoking this idea, there must be some solution, and we hope that some solution will come soon on this issue. Sir, I again welcome on behalf of Indian Dairy Engineering Association. Dr. Sani was too eager to receive you, but unfortunately, happening at his personal level, he could not be here today to welcome you. And on behalf of Dr. Sani, I do welcome you to this occasion. Thank you very much, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Now I request Dr. G. Mahesh Kumar to please present the seminar report.
Now we are in the last phase of IDEA 11th National Convention. Chairman sir, chief guest of today's function, Dr. Asim Jha, Engineer Chup, and Dr. Vasnik sir, and Varmaji, and the delegates, invited speakers. Now I am going to present the 2 days deliberation took place since yesterday till today. So we had many invited eminent speakers who spoke at length about three important topics. One was skill development, and second topic was engineering solution, and third topic was quality education. So I will highlight the deliberation took place yesterday and today by the eminent speakers, which will go as a recommendation to the policy makers to implement the important outcome of today's IDEA convictions. So yesterday we had first session, technical session. The title was Make in India Initiatives in Manufacture of Dairy Processing Equipment. So in that session we had four eminent speakers. The first speaker was Dr. R.P. Singh. So he's a CEO of Food and Biotech Engineers, Faridabad. He spoke at length about the Make in India initiative he has started to manufacture spray dryers and evaporators. Otherwise, we had to import spray dryers and evaporators from Denmark because of companies like Food and Biotech. So the spray dryers and evaporators today we are able to make in India. That too cost effective and the quality is at par with European quality. That is the Make in India initiative started by Food and Biotech engineers. Second, the invited and lead speaker was Rakesh Chopra. He is from General Manager REIL. So he spoke at length about use of non-conventional energy sources for procurement and processing of raw milk, use of solar energy, and the instruments used for quality assessment of raw milk. And third speaker we had Engineer M.C. Chawla, Director. He also spoke at length about PHEs. So design of PHE, design of import substitute, design of PHE, in-house development of PHE for various applications in India. Again, it is a Make in India initiative started from food process engineers and associates. Third speaker was me. Dr. Mahesh Kumar, I spoke about the skill development. So without skill nothing can happen in this country. That's why there is a lot of skill development, making initiatives are required. There is a gap, and that gap has to be filled. That has to be filled by upcoming entrepreneurs, upcoming dairy engineers of the country. The second session was on engineering solution in automation, energy and supply chain management. So we had six leading speakers, eminent speakers. The first speaker was Engineer Somesh Chup, and he is the Director of Reliable Control System. He spoke the importance of automation in production of quality dairy products. He spoke the importance of automation in conservation of energy. And we had a second speaker, very good speaker. So we all talking about BMC. Today BMCs are culprit to us. They are getting all the problems. And we are not addressed to BMC. We have copied the BMCs from abroad. So always we say BMCs are good or bad. I also endorse the opinion of Dr. Ravi Kumar. BMCs are not that good, but instead we should go for a instant training units. And third speaker was our friend AS Kojare. So he spoke at length about supply chain. So that starting from collection of milk, what issues we have, cold chain management, and preserving the dairy products in quality conditions. So that was the spoke about 30-40 minutes about supply chain management. And next speaker was Dr. P. Barnwal, Principal Scientist, NDRI, Dairy Engineering Division. He spoke about use of thermic fluid. So thermic fluid is the one which many of us do not know. It has got potential use. And he rightly said, we can rise the temperature up to 350 degrees without increasing pressure. We don't require pressure vessel. Just 8 inches SS, 1.2 mm SS sheet is enough. So, but you can raise the temperature for preparation of right product. You can develop it, you can develop heat exchangers. The spray dryers, which are working with turbine fluid as a source for auto generators are the best compared to direct fired or steam fired. So we always recommend turbine fluid heated auto generator instead of other options available. So next speaker was Dr. Chitra Nayak, senior scientist NDRI Karnal. He spoke about again automation. Today is era of automation. Every equipment we manufacture differently. Earlier automation was a tough subject. Today we have gone up to operating equipment through your remote. I don't have to go to Karnataka to operate my pasteurizer. Sitting indoor, throw my mobile, throw Wi-Fi, and we can operate the equipment, any equipment, and where. So Dr. Chitra Nayak, he spoke very fundamental, fundamentals were depicted very well, we realize the importance of automation. And without automation, no equipment can be manufactured. Today, automation is not expensive, it's cheap. So earlier, PLC was, it was our dream. Now, PLC is available for 5,000, 10,000. And HMI is available for 4,000, 5,000. Right? And we had the last speaker, Dr. J.K. Dabas. And he is a senior technical officer from NDRI, Delhi Engineering Division. He spoke about the importance of energy again. Role of refrigeration, conservation of energy, how to conserve energy, as refrigeration plant is very important in dairy industry. If refrigeration plant is good, everything is good. And that is a guzzler which takes a lot of power. So he spoke about the how to conserve energy, how to save energy, how to reduce the energy by using inverter and using the best compressors. And we had third session, we had oral presentation by funding upcoming research. So we had about 15 upcoming engineers who spoke about various topics, starting from milk production, milk processing, and value addition, thereafter marketing and cold chain management. And today's session, very hot session, and we had three eminent speakers. The first speaker was Dr. Desai sir. He really spoke, what is required for our dairy science colleges. Unfortunately, so there is a big gap between industry and the colleges. So we need to praise, very important, we need to praise. If we do not praise, and our colleges cannot grow. And he said, the opening remarks was, today's graduates are unemployable. Why? Because they do not have skills. Who is responsible? All of us are responsible. All the teachers of this country who are teaching the subjects of dairy technology are dairy engineering are important. So we need to impart a real skill. He said, the technology graduates, once he's out, he should be able to operate straight right back. Unfortunately, none of the students for our colleges, they are incapable. Because we have not infused the skill. The intellectuals are really indicated. So we will make, we have so many teachers, really make prompt to them. And the lacuna in our dairy colleges are, we don't have facilities. And I believe me, many colleges do not have spray dryers. Many colleges do not have operators. Many colleges do not have teachers also. So that is the real reason. I'll give you an example of our own college. Our the biggest department, we are only two teachers. Somehow we are managing, really we are managing very well. And there are colleges, we are not, they do not have teachers. That is the main reason. And so that has to be taken care. So, and we had one more eminent speaker, Dr. S.N. Jha. Jha sir spoke, he spoke really, everything was good. So, he spoke at length about the. So the importance of dairy engineers. So dairy engineers means we always think dairy equipment manufacturers after processing. But our role is there to look after the animals. As I said, we should have it, we should develop a software, should develop the sensors so that to know the condition of the cow. Very important. Cow has come to estrus. Cow is suffering from fever. Who will know? I will not touch. If I am suffering from fever, immediately message will go to somebody. But now cannot speak. So there is a need. So your dairy engineering intervention is really required for the welfare of the cow. If cow is hungry, we should give the message so that I'll give feed. And we should not make the cow to stop. If it has come to his
this process will come to once today it has come, we inseminate after 2 days. Then we cannot conceive. So that kind of cells are we should develop as an engineer. It's a role, it's a challenge, it's a challenge in front of you. And Jayasar said development of cooling and heating system using Peltier effect. Sir, I would like to bring it to your notice. In our university, we have started developing this Peltier effect based milk cooling and heating system. It's almost 50% over. And beauty of this Peltier, I think all of you must be knowing. Still, I would like to share. Beauty of this Peltier effect is we do not require any compressor. Small, the size of the Peltier effect chip is only 2 inch by 2 inch. That's it. No compressor, no condenser, no evaporator, and only your power supply is required. So the cooling, today the issue with Peltier effect system is the COP. COP is only small. So maybe budding engineers you have to bring the COP to 4. Then tomorrow there will not be any compressor. No compressor, no maintenance, no condenser, no global warming. So thank you, sir. We will address this issue. And sir also told there is a loss of 0.9% post harvest loss of milk, big volume. Quite our country, today we are speaking. We are the number one in the world. If 1% milk is lost from milking stage till it reaches the end use, just think of the amount of revenue that is going to get up. Apart from that, we are polluting. Apart from losing the milk, we are also troubling our environment. We cannot once milk goes to EDP, we spend money. A lot of money is invested for collecting the milk, chilling the milk, processing the milk, transportation of milk, again packing the milk. If you lose 1.91%, just imagine the implication on the economy. And sir also insisted for the development of miniature pellet making machine, miniature sweet making machine. Yes, MTech students, PhD students are here. I think you should take up this. It's not difficult to develop. And they're very, very useful. And sir also told today, maybe after some time, definitely we'll not have water. And dairy plant, we say how much water is required. 2 times the capacity. 20 lakh liters of dairy every day consumes 40 lakh liters of water. Where that water is going? What is going to get EDP? You have to spend a lot of money for treating the effluent. So yes, he said use air plus water for cleaning operations. If you are traveling to flight, if you go to washroom, you can see total flushing takes place by 10 ml of water, rest will be air. See, they have learned how to conserve water. Let's bring the technology back to our living plan. Water plus air, maybe CAP. Use the technology, and we have this ice breaking also. And water with air gives really economy to our dairy plants. And edible packaging, he spoke about edible packaging. And so inbuilding of teacher, very important. See, what we do, we take in the same college, MTech in the same college, PhD in the same college, assistant professor same college, associate professor team. So we will not be exposed. So it is a policy, registrar should make a policy that after BTEC, you should not be admitted to MTech. You should go to some other college. Good happen. After MTech, you should go to PhD somewhere else. And recruitment is state policy, we cannot speak. But this education registrar can have control. Earlier, this was implemented. After my BTEC, I never got admission to our college. I came to Karnal. And first I went to Anand, then I came to Karnal. So because why I went to Karnal? Because there was a riding class. I should not do MTech at Delhi Central Bangalore. Otherwise, I would have joined there only. Right? And remuneration students, yes. Once students go to advanced, right, they should be paid very well. Sir, we have in Bangalore Delhi Central College, we have pressurized the government. Today, all the students who are undergoing advanced training are paid 12,000 rupees per month by the government of Karnataka, and they will pay 8 hours and their 12,000 rupees paid as a remuneration to them. And we lobbied through some of every student is paid 12,000 rupees as a and vacant post, very important. And every college, including NDRA headquarters, we don't have teachers. What we can teach? So many subjects. So teachers have to be recruited. And so too much paperwork. Yes. So every day we submit report. We spend half day in submitting reports, papers. And lost, we mentioned, out of our thinking. Yes. Stereotyping to stop. So we think something which is not possible. So, and at the third speak, thank you, sir. I am really inspired by the today's speakers summaries. Dr. Jha sir, your words were really important for the improving dairy education and improving the quality of milk processing. And Desai sir, so that's what you said is really required for it. You are linking the dairy education and industry. Very otherwise, dairy industry will be different and education will be different. So, and we had a last speaker, Nirja Tandon madam, and she very important. Health is wealth. So if there is no health, whatever wealth we have, definitely business. So she spoke the important. This is today. We have issues with our grandfather, great grandfather, grandmother. Issues of mental disorders. So it's very difficult to diagnose. And all of us will start. Early morning, if there is a problem in my family, I'll not be able to teach well. So we have addressed this problem. And second issue, if you have the diabetes, almost everybody. Every one person out of three is suffering from diabetes. So, food, very important is food. So, we are eating whatever is available, especially junk food. What if it is advertised by beautiful stuff, definitely we will buy, including my son. So, now it's a time to eat good food and keep our health. So these are the outcome of 2 days deliberations. So, this will be going as a recommendation to the policy makers of the country. Our Jasar is a representing of the ICM. Sir has got definitely implement many things with this report. I say thank you for patience hearing and thank you for supporting this this IDA convention. Thank you once again.
Thank you, sir. Now it's the time for presentation of best postal and best oral presentation award. First is best oral presentation. We had first session on equipment design. First place goes to engineer Ankit Deep on the topic of design and performance evolution of CIP system for system for 3-stage scrap surface heat exchanger. I request Dr. Jason Jassel to please present the award. Second place goes to Dr. I.A. Chauhan on the topic design, development and performance evolution of SSHG for manufacturing of CAPE.
The third prize goes to Dr. P. Verma for design, development and testing of thermic based heating system. Moving on to the next category in the oral presentation, process engineering and optimization. The first prize goes to engineer H.R. Patel for protein exchanger of dairy industry. Newer technology section. In this section, the first prize goes to Dr. G.S. Meena for effect of sodium tripolyphosphate and sodium hexamethyl phosphate. Second prize goes to Mr. Vishal Thakur for design upscaling of milk heating system. Now coming on to the poster session, in the category of process engineering and optimization, first prize goes to engineer. Third prize goes to engineer S.K. Singh for solar pasteurization of milk.
Now coming in the newer technology section for poster, first prize goes to Dr. Ganga Sahib Meena for shelf life enhancement of buffalo milk tea woven through cotton technology. There is a tie for third position. The third prize goes jointly to Mr. Vishal Thakur and Mr. Dhruvay Patel in newer technology section. So, Mr. Vishal Thakur.
Initiatives and manufacture of dairy processing equipment. We had a chairman, it's H.S. Grewal. I request you to please collect the momentum on the stage. And session coordinator is G.S. Meena, Dr. G.S. Meena. Dr. G.S. Meena, he has also been awarded for the best oral and poster presentation. The first speaker in the technical session 1 is Engineer Amit Singh. MD comes CEO, food and garlic engineer. I request you to please come and collect the mobile. Next speaker was Mr. Rakesh Chopra, General Manager, Rajasthan Electronics and Instruments Limited. Followed by Engineer MC Chawla, Director, Process Engineers and Associates. I request you please come on the guys. The next speaker in the technical session 1 is Dr. G. Mahesh Kumar, Head Dairy Engineering, DSC Nepal. We had technical session 2 on engineering solutions for automation, engineering and energy and supply chain management in dairy industry. We have engineer S.T. Agarwal for as a chairman of the session. I request Dr. S.C. Lassa to present. We had engineer Sanjeev Sharma as the co-chairman of the session. Engineer S.K. Chowdhury sir as the wrap-up here. And I request Ms. Engineer S.T.F. Chauhan to attend as the session coordinator. Please collect the moment. The speakers in the technical session 2 are Engineer Somesh Chur, Director, Reliable Control Solutions. Second speaker was Dr. Ravi Kumar S., Dean, College of Dairy Science and Technology, Tirupati. Followed by Dr. A.S. Khodre, Assistant Professor, Vivekananda College, Aurangabad. Next speaker was Dr. P. Barangwa, Principal and Dairy Engineering Division, ICR and DR Kannam. Dr. Chitra Naik, Senior Scientist, Dairy Engineering Division, ICR and DR Kannam.
Dr. J.K. Dabas, ACTO, Dairy Engineering Division, ICAR India, Karnataka. Dr. J.K. Dabas, ACTO, Dairy Engineering Division, ICAR India, Karnataka. This session was on newer challenges in research, education and manpower development in the dairy sector. Dr. S. Ravikumar was acted as chairman of the session. Engineer Vishnu Mitra, who was acted as co-seminar, I request him to please come to the moment on the stage. I request Dr. S. Ravikumar sir also to please collect the momentum of the group. I request Dr. S. Kusra Nayak sir, who acted as a rapporteur for the final session.
Now I request Engineer Sporty, who acted as the session coordinator, to collect the momentum. Engineer Sporty, please. Now I request the President to present the momentum to Dr. S.N. Jha. I request Dr. S.K. Chaudhary to receive the memento.
So, I mean, now you know, Dr. Chaudhary has come. He has put in a lot of effort. So, I request Chaudhary sir to share the task, please. So, since morning he is after, you know, transport, you know, so, you know, today there's a moment of this, that, you know, things. And he was very good to come here. So, Chaudhary sir, Pajay, please share the task.
Sir, I request S. Yadavala sir to present the moment to Dr. S. N. Jha sir. The executive members who have worked for this seminar is Engineer R. K. Chuk sir. I request to please collect the moment to. Engineer Pawan Kumar. The second speaker is the technical session speaker, Dr. H.K. Desai, Advisor, Dairy Operations, Amul Dairy. I request him to please cover the moment. The judges for the poster presentation was Professor Bhushan Meshram. I request him to please collect the memento. The other judges were K.L. Arora sir, A.S. Kumbhe sir, and MVP for the coordinator. I request anybody from BME, Mr. Bharat Palya is present, or Mr. Sunil Deo, for the is the coordinator for all the events. I request Mr. Engineer Pawan Kumar to please collect the momentum.
Now it is good afternoon.
There are so many small from micro pockets. New design. I am putting it out because. Good afternoon to all of you. Again, I say that it is my great privilege to be here, first time in the idea. And I have just asked the president idea, what is the annual fee of this idea membership or life member. It is not much. So I want to be the life member of this association. And I requested some of you that collect the money and give me the receipt if possible. Today, or I can transfer the money. Online, because most of the transactions already being done by online by all the government officials, almost 99%. Our all issues are doing the transfer, 100% digital transfer. Due to this government initiative, so we are in good position. So you can transfer anytime, 1100 rupees is not much. And I think the idea requires membership driving. We should drive the members and all dairy plants should donate some more money as a corporate member. And for that, the NDRL scientists and technical officers should take the leads to go each and every appreciable dairy plants and collect money from them. Some will make him willingly, some may not be willingly, but once if you go once or twice or remind him number of times, you will get something. And by that way, membership will be enhanced. And another session, before coming to my topic, another session is that do some more activities. Do some more activities so that idea should be visible. And for visibility, there are so many media nowadays. You see, media organized, Bharti Media, I think. I don't think that idea is having Twitter account, idea is having Facebook account. Someone should open a Facebook account and load everything on that and forcefully put it into the other accounts.
there are certain software, certain techniques in that you can make presence felt to others that IBI is doing some good things for Delhi and good engineering of the country. And by that way, visibility will increase. Certainly, the participation will increase. Once participation will increase, certainly economic condition will increase. And it was a good idea yesterday, GV, I heard that you are going to have a plan of your own as a headquarter. That is the first requirement should be. घर अपना होना चाहिए. बिना घर का, बिना language का कोई country नहीं होता. बिना जमीन का, बिना भाषा का कोई देश नहीं होता. तो यदि आपका अपना headquarter permanent हो जाएगा, that is the best. You should put all the efforts on that. And also I suggest, as I have suggested in the morning, although I don't want to repeat anything which I spoke in the morning session, that each of you which are having a good amount of turnover, industry should give some consultancy under the umbrella of idea. Under the umbrella of idea, so that suppose you have 10 lakh rupees consultancy or 10 lakh rupees consultancy, 10% should go to idea and 90% should go to the concerned institute, something like that, the body should decide. And by that way, you will offer all the kinds of help to IDEA or the scientists. And once scientists will get something through their science, he or she should feel proud that they have got something earned as a royalty, as a consultant from their science. So that will give more satisfaction than anything else. So this is the idea or an idea to have a better future for IDEA. So this, I thank all of you who invite me, and I request all the scientists, my most of the lectures are mostly of devotional front. I want to motivate the new scientists, and in morning I said that you are the most important person of this world, who are the food givers. So first you should feel happy. And how you can feel happy, I can give you some tips, 15 tips, of which almost every, all tips I follow. I will tell you that no one in the world can demotivate me. Though I also get demotivated sometimes, but immediately I get in one day or 2 days or 2 hours, 3 hours, again on a square, back to a square, on my own nature. So same thing I would like to share with you. But one thing I will tell you, that you have to perform, and perform only when you can read the things. जो भी B.Tech, M.Tech, Ph.D. ने पढ़ाई हुआ है, जरूरी नहीं है दुनिया वही है. जैसे बता रहे इम्प्लायबिलिटी क्यों नहीं है, क्योंकि वो किताब के आगे आप जाते नहीं है. यू हैव टू गो बियॉन्ड दैट बुक्स, यू हैव टू गो बियॉन्ड दैट टीचर हैव टोल्ड. ग्रेजुएशन पोस्ट ग्रेजुएशन मींस दैट इम्प्रूवमेंट इन द आईक्यू लेवल. लेटर ऑन यू हैव टू थिंक योरसेल्फ. दैट्स व्हाई आई हैव टोल्ड इन द मॉर्निंग सेशन दैट टीचर शुड लेट द स्टूडेंट थिंकर्स, नॉट द ग्रेजुएट्स, नॉट द पोस्ट ग्रेजुएट. दे आर मेड अप thinker, they can do anything. I will tell you one story. When I was in Japan, many places I found that many agriculture graduates are working in marketing. I asked him, why you are doing that? He said that I like marketing, but I am graduated. I have knowledge of agriculture, but I can excel in other fields, electronics also in marketing. And their company are hiring them. They are doing better and better. So, I studied agriculture engineering, then post harvest engineering. Then I was never thinking to be posted in NDI. And I posted in NDI, I did some work, and everyone still remembers me. That is my earnings. And then I studied, I did not study non destructive evaluation of food quality. But I have written a book, two books, one published by the Elsevier, other published by the Springer. And I am happy to share with you that they are sending me around 50, 60 rupees every year as a royalty. And the money amount is not the important thing. Amount is that I am getting. some acknowledgement which I will get throughout my life as an scholar, as a scientist. So you are recognized scientist for the world. So you should think proud, and feeling proud will work as a catalyst for you. Once you feel proud, if you feel proud, it will work catalyst for you, and you can do something extra, something different. I always say, please don't do different things. Don't put everything in your basket. Put one thing, but do differently. Do one thing, but do differently, so that I will catch you. When I started my M.Tech project, that commodity was not known at all. No one was knowing. I was in problem. No one was willing to give me the degree of Master of Technology. But I was carrying that commodity in my pocket always, that one day people will understand. And I was in the, my jitne mein thale mujhe yahi project karna hai. Karna hai, koi guide bano ya na bano, mujhe project yahi karna hai. And finally I got success. Though the machine could not work well in master course, at once and twice it worked well, but later did not work well. But everyone eyes were on me. Even the director IIT Kharagpur was coming to see my project, my machine, in the department. And all department students were knowing that director K.L. Chopra is going to see his project frequently. So mera sina chada hota tha, to sab janta hai mera project director dekhne jata hai. That was a catalyst. And later on when machine was developed, no one was to take her. Koi taker nahi tha uska. Koi janta hai nahi tha, lekin importance kya hai, koi nahi janta tha. Lekin main uska importance janta tha. I want the condition to importance. And then I joined ICR and I tried to continue my work. And no one allowed me to continue work on that because it was in India. NDRI were told that NDRI mandate is only milk. So how I can work on the horticulture crop? I cannot work on horticulture crop. Then I made the key remix of that horticulture crop faster, which I told in the morning. And NDRI sanctioned the project. So I want to say that if you are the convinced, you do one thing, do differently. Do one thing, do continuously. Any scientist, any industrialist, continuity maintain the perfection. Continuity will give you the recognition. Continuity will give you the output of tangible amount. So don't leave the things in between and change the course. Another that non-destructive method only started in 2002 with food safety, but no one want to do that work. But number of times after failure, I went again and again to present the case. But someone came and they understood that this is the future technology on which we should work. And everywhere you write the name of non-destructive method, it will be known. And it will give me the satisfaction with it. So we want to be known, you want to be known forever, you should think that you are the biggest person. Once you are the biggest person of the world, then nothing is required. You do on doing, you go on doing, and things will come automatically to you. So with these words, I thank all of you to hear for becoming happy, which I forgot. For becoming happy, I should tell you. Your time is less, I also have to do, which I am practicing. Actually, what happened last year, every year I go for health checkup, comprehensive health checkup. There is a scheme of government of India, and doctor told me that your weight is very high, you should reduce the weight as quickly as possible, otherwise you will be the diabetic in 2 years, maybe 2 years, 3 years, 4 years. And I asked, requested the director, the doctor to give some medicine. He told that you are well educated, it seems. There is no medicine. Do some exercise, 1 hour, walking and other things. And you will reduce your weight. And at that time, I was not sure that whether I would be able to reduce or not. So I was very much nervous that what to do. Diabetes should not happen to me. I was always satisfied that I don't have any anxiety. Why diabetes should come? But weight had increased after coming to Delhi from Ludhiana. So first job was to reduce the weight. And successful, I tell you, in 4-5 months, I reduced 40-50 kilograms of weight without consulting anybody. Because one day I was alone in my office, I bolted the office from inside, and I thought I am the food technology, food scientist, who I should make my own chart. By my own knowledge, I made the food chart and daily activity. And I came back to home and gave that chart to my wife. That this I have to follow from tomorrow. And some of the things which she was not knowing how she can make that cook. I told you are very good in cooking, you can try. Go on trying and 10-15 days, after 10-15 days you will be master of making cooking that things. And same thing happened. And I was not sure, but after 15-20 days, again I went to the same clinic that you lost that club near Connaught Place. And I found that 2.5 kilo weight was reduced. So it was again catalyst for me. I come to Kerala. Formula is working. And I started doing every month around 3 kilo I reduced the weight. I can share with WhatsApp if someone is interested. They can send the WhatsApp. I was thinking to share it on the Facebook, but I stopped that. When we need it, people should get it. Otherwise, the value of the things reduced. You give free of cost, then nothing is important. So reduce that. Some of the tips I will share. First tips which my grandparents gave in the childhood. I have acknowledged my book to my grandparents. And he was telling in the beginning in my childhood that santosam paramam sukham. Bahut frequently bola karte hain santosam paramam sukham. Aur ek meva santosh ke pher mein meva phalta. का ये दो सेंटेंस संतोष के पेड़ माने संतोष इफ यू हैव सेटिस्फैक्शन ट्री यू विल गेट द मेवा ऑफ दैट ट्री सो व्हाट एवर यू हैव यू शुड फील सेटिस्फाइड आई थिंक यू शुड थैंक द गॉड फर्स्ट थिंग यू थैंक द गॉड व्हाट एवर यू हैव क्योंकि आपसे बुढ़े भी बहुत लोग हैं 1.3 करोड़ अरब आदमी है इस देश में आपसे बहुत नीचे है आप देखो तो आपको लगेगा यू आर द अराउंड 1% 2% यू शुड फील सैटिस्फाइड मोर देन सैटिस्फाइड वंस यू आर सैटिस्फाइड यू विल नेवर गेट एनर्जी एंड एवरीथिंग यू हैव एंड एवरीथिंग यू शुड नॉट हैव व्हाट देयर आर ऑलवेज इंग्रेडिएंट सो हाउ इफ यू आर नॉट सैटिस्फाइड देन यू राइट 10 थिंग्स Write 10 things which you have better in memory. आपका minimum 20-25 साल के age होगा यहाँ जो भी बैठे हैं उसमें 10 अच्छा memory को आप लिख कर रखो अपने मोबाइल में और time to time को आपको remind करेगा ये हुआ था photo रखो अपने दीवार पे लगाओ room में लगाओ office में लगाओ 10 best memory and that will give you more happiness. Focus on those good things instead of things which you don't have. Next tip, practice physical activity. Physical activity practice. यदि आप exercise करते हो तो आप कितना भी चाहोगे बुरा चीज आपके दिमाग में आएगा. If you are concentrated, for some time you will be free from that. Practicing, for example, I do. I always go for morning walk. Though I did not arrive in the morning by childhood. मैं सुबह उठ के कभी नहीं पढ़ाई किया वो मेरे लिए बहुत बड़ा काम था बट सिंस वन ईयर आई एम राइजिंग एट 4:30, 4:45, 15, 20 मिनट्स आई थैंक द गॉड जॉब एंड गो फॉर रन और वॉक और जॉगिंग व्हाट एवर यू से फॉर वन आवर 15 मिनट्स एंड आई कंज्यूम द कैलोरी अराउंड 600 किलो कैलोरी इन वन स्ट्रेच मॉर्निंग Initially it was difficult, and then now it is habit. If I don't go, my eye opens around 5:15 and 10, and I have to go out on that day. So when I reached yesterday evening, I first searched where to go in the morning. Unfortunately, there is a big, very good garden in front of that hotel. So that is, and when 1 hour I jog, hardly anything comes in the mind. So it gives you the peace, and your mind become more fertile. So do that. That is very important thing. Second important thing. I say at least 30 minutes. I do more. You do at least 30 minutes. One of the morning speakers said that never miss the breakfast. Third thing. Kitna bhi aapko vajan karna ho, lekin breakfast nahi chhodna. But what to eat? You must eat certain selected thing. If you want to reduce the weight, otherwise you eat everything. Breakfast you do according to your likeness, but do full stomachs. You can reduce, you can skip lunch, you can skip evening things with little nuts and other things, but do the breakfast. Actually, breakfast is important because it is the first thing which sends the energy to the mind. And body is because ICMR also says that I should not say much. And must watch the calorie, how much calorie you eat. If you want to reduce 3 kg per month, you burn the calorie 600-700 calorie every day, and don't eat more than 1400 calorie in a day. Usually people eat 2500 calorie in a day, usually. So 1500 calorie in a day, you can watch, you can make the list. Or if you are needy to reduce, then I can forward you the same thing in my mobile, in your things. So, but don't miss the eat as much as food you eat. Fourth tip, which I am doing since morning. Be assertive. Assertive ka matlab barwas nahi hona hai, jhagda nahi hona. But if you are the convinced person, you say your boss, you say your viewpoint anywhere. You will stick to your viewpoint. Assertive banna. Or say to the people, no. You should learn how to say no. You should learn. You always know. Most of the people nowadays say yes, 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 ma'am, yes, sir, yes, madam. If you are not able to do perfectly, if you are lack of time, if you cannot do things correctly, say no. But you should learn how to say no. Sira no bolna jadi hai to aaj ke zamane mein acha nahi hai. Isliye aapko seekhna hai kaise no karna. But you must be assertive. You must tell your mind. You must speak your mind. This is my pet word since beginning. I know Dr. H. I. Vichandan, many people must be knowing he was a professor. Also had in India like now. He was found out by this assertiveness at that time. But he suggested me, and this sentence I am using from him. He told me that Dr. Charles must learn how to say no. I was telling no many places. So he suggested me that you must learn how to say no. And then after that, I am still learning that how to say no and trying. And same suggestion is to you. He was very good chemical engineer and doing very good research and many things. I think he assessed as in on its many generations of daily engineering, eating, taking food. It was done by Dr. H. R. Chandani first, and I think it's Dr. S. Salman. So this was the fourth tip. I am again taking more time, but I want to put my point of view. I am assertive. I already tell you. So I am sorry, if you don't like anyone, you can leave the house, you can go, but it will help you somewhere. Everyone wants to be happy. So be assertive. That was fourth, fifth point. You spend your money on experiences. Spend your money on experiences. Log yahan par khareedne jata hai, ye khareed liya, wo khareed liya, 15 din ke baad wo kharab ho jata hai, aur defect ho jata hai. So it is better experience with travel. I say travel. Jadi aapko zyada kharch karne ki बीमार है तो अभी नया एक क्रूज चला है कम आज कल से मुंबई टू गोवा गो ऑन दैट एक्सपीरियंस बी वेरी हैप्पी एंड सी द एक्सपीरियंस ऑफ सी एंड अदर थिंग्स एंड नॉलेज शेयर द नॉलेज गेट द नॉलेज ट्रैवल थ्रू आउट इंडिया थ्रू आउट द वर्ल्ड A study found that 75% of people felt happier when they invested their money in travel, courses and classes. Also buy some courses and classes related to which you like. And you will think that you have to spend money rightly. Instead of buying the good mobile, While only the rest said that felt happier when buying things. Or 30% who possibly think buy permission. Face your challenges. I'll tell you, face your challenges. Many times, many people postpone the things. God said, उसको लग रहा है ये क्या हो जाएगा चलो बाद में देखेंगे बहुत आदमी कहते हैं जो आप बाद में इसको करो तो ज्यादा अच्छा होगा डोंट If there is a challenge, do that challenge today. मरना है तो साला आज ही मर जाओ कल के लिए क्यों मैंने आप मन ही मन कल तक मर रहे हो इससे अच्छा आज ही मर जाओ वॉट एवर यू वॉन्ट टू फेस टूमोरो डे आफ्टर टूमोरो आफ्टर वन मंथ फेस टूडे आई आई एम श्योर दैट यू विल कम अप विद दैट चैलेंज यू सी साइकिल चलाना तब तक लोग नहीं सीखता है जब तक साइकिल से गिरता नहीं साइकिल चलाना किसी को देख के नहीं सिखा जा सकता कार चलाना किसी को देख के नहीं सिखा सकता आपको डर से मुक्त होना है एंड दैट मुक्ति विल ओनली कम व्हेन यू विल डू योरसेल्फ यू विल डू द थिंग्स सो फेस द चैलेंज एज क्विकली एज पॉसिबल एंड डू द थिंग्स अकॉर्डिंगली यू मेरा ये पासवर्ड प्रोटेक्टर है बार बार चला जाता है सो दिस वॉज द फिफ्थ ऐसे 15 है I'll go with you. Then, don't be assertive, then spend your money on experience, face your challenges. The studies show that the more you postpone something, the more anxiety and tension you generate within yourself. You see, tension, jab ye aap mein generate hota hai, to usse BP hota hai. Anxiety aap mein generate hota hai, to usse biochemical reaction hota hai, andar. Aur usse शुगर बढ़ता है सो टेंशन एंड बीपी इज द बाय प्रोडक्ट ऑफ बीपी एंड देन शुगर इज द बाय प्रोडक्ट ऑफ एनर्जी एंड टेंशन सो यू डोंट अलाउ टू डू दैट एंड यू विल फ्री यू विल बी फ्री फ्रॉम दिस टू वाइड स्प्रेडिंग फास्ट स्प्रेडिंग डिजीजेस सो टेंशन को रखना नहीं है आगे पुराना काम होता है टेंशन देने का है देने का नहीं यदि आपसे नहीं होता है तो फाइंड दैट वन बी असर्टिव टू सम अदर वन एंड गेट इट डन सेवन टिप्स से पुट एवरीवेयर नाइस मेमोरी ऑलरेडी हैव टू प्रेजेंट एंड फोटो ऑफ योर लव्ड वन अपने लव्ड वन का फोटो जिससे जिसे आपको खुशी मिलती है उसको मोबाइल में रखो जब भी ट्रैवल मिले ऑफ टाइम मिले उसको बार बार देखो रूम में रखो ऑफिस में रखो एंड सी दैट फिल योर फ्रिज योर कंप्यूटर Your desk, your room, your life are beautiful memories and remember them again and again. Always greet and be nice to other people. सबको आपको अच्छा समझो ज्यादातर उनके मन में निगेटिव आता है शो नहीं करके सबने माने जानवर भी जो है अच्छा आदमी है हम लोगों ने बचपन में कहानी पढ़ा था पानी और फूल वो स्वतंत्रता के टाइम में लिखा हुआ था टेंथ में पढ़ा था मानव के अंदर में दोनों चीज है जानवर भी है और आदमी भी है आप पर निर्भर करता है उससे क्या लेना है वो निर्भर करता है जो बॉस है उसको क्या लेना है उससे सो यू थिंक ऑन दैट एंड डू दैट नाइंथ थिंग इज वियर कंफर्टेबल शूज जूते मैं ज्यादातर चमड़े वाला जूता नहीं पहनता दो कारण है एक तो मुझे कंफर्टेबल नहीं लगता है दूसरा मॉर्निंग में मुझे जॉगिंग करना है तो टूर पर चले जाते हैं तो दो जूते लेके क्यों जाऊं कंफर्टेबिलिटी मुझे अपना देखना है दूसरा क्या कहेगा उससे मुझे मतलब नहीं है व्हाट अदर्स से डोंट थिंक ऑन दैट से सी व्हाट यू थिंक what is comfortable for you. कपड़े भी ऐसे ही हैं, कपड़े जो आपको कंफर्टेबल फील होता है, बॉडी को कंफर्टेबल फील होता है, वही पहने. और आपको और ये ना कि सामने में जरूर जाए एंड सी दैट व्हाट इज हैपनिंग. सो शूज कपड़े वही पहनना है जो हमें अच्छा लगे. हाँ, टेक केयर ऑफ सम. कभी कभी अपना पोस्चर पर ध्यान दो. टेक केयर ऑफ योर पोस्चर. जब आप खड़ा होकर चलते हैं या बोलते हैं ये, और कभी कभी दर्पण के सामने अच्छे से मन संवर के जरूर अपने पोस्चर को ध्यान दो. एंड बी हैप्पी दैट यू आर द ब्यूटीफुल माने बेस्ट माने क्या कहें सबसे सुंदर दुनिया का आदमी है. और जो जो आदमी आपको ग्रीट करता है उसको आप उससे ज्यादा बड़े शब्द में ग्रीट करिए और अप्रेस करिए. तो लुक लुक इज ऑल्सो इम्पोर्टेंट आपके सामने. Listen to music. आजकल मुझे दिल्ली में आने का टाइम के अभाव में मैं देखा है इस पार्क में गार्डन में बहुत सारे पुराने पुराने गाने लोग जरा बजा रहे थे मोबाइल से. और मुझे पुरानी दिन याद आने लगी. मैं सोचा हूँ कि मैं भी अपने मोबाइल में डॉक्टर बनवा. मुझे बहुत याद था जब वो इंडिया से मैं था उससे पहले मैं सीकट में था. एंड म्यूजिक रियली रिलीव यू. आपका यदि गुनगुनाने लगे तो यू विल बी रिमूव्ड फ्रॉम ऑल योर टेंशन एनर्जी. तो म्यूजिक सुनो और जरूर सुनो और उससे आपका टेंशन बहुत दूर हो जाएगा बहुत. और इसको मैं अभी अपना नहीं रहा हूँ लेकिन मैं आपको इसको इम्प्रूव करूँगा अपने लाइफ में. Then 12th number is what you eat has an impact on your mood. What do you eat has an impact on your mood. Do not skip meals. मतलब meal जैसे मैडम भी मॉर्निंग उठा रही थी कोई meal छोड़ना नहीं है. आप frequently खाओ लेकिन क्या खाते हो उसको आप जरूर वॉच करो. Do not skip meals. Eat light every 3 to 4 hours and keep glucose level stable. मेरा डाइट चार्ट है वो glucose level आपको बताएगा क्या होता है. Avoid excess white fruit and sugar. Eat everything and vary your food. As much as you can vary, change karte rahna. 13 is that take care of yourself first. ये मैं आज से नहीं कर रहा हूँ. मैं 2002 में मैं जापान में था. I'll tell you. When I went to Japan, I went with my full family first time. Making my GPF zero. Knowing very well that मैंने अपना पूरा जीरो कर लिया. मैं लौट के आऊंगा यदि किसी कारण से मेरे पास कुछ नहीं है. Because I'm farmer in fully farmer. Otherwise farmer in no backing. Family के साथ गया but my wife was sick at that time. And very every day I had to go to hospital in Japan from the day first I landed. And there was a problem of language. And I thank to the professor. जो प्रोफेसर हमारे साथ थे वो डॉक्टर टाटा ऐसा माचो का ही वाज अकॉम्पनिंग मी एवरी डे बिकॉज ऑफ द लैंग्वेज प्रॉब्लम. नो वन वाज नोइंग इंग्लिश एंड आई वाज नॉट नोइंग जापानीज एट ऑल. वेरी डिफिकल्ट. इवन डॉक्टर वाज नॉट वाज नॉट नोइंग द इंग्लिश. एंड 10-15 डेज आई वाज नॉट गोइंग माय ऑफिस एवरी डे ऑन टाइम. वन डे आई फेल्ट रेडी. अपोलोजाइज professor, because I was considering myself very sincere in India. वहाँ जाके मुझे लगा मेरे से पहले बहुत लोग यहाँ ऑफिस में आ जाते हैं. और मैंने बहुत कोशिश किया तो मैं कुछ लोगों से पहले पहुँचूँ वहाँ ऑफिस लेकिन मैं नहीं कर पाया. फिर मैंने उनसे पूछा कि मैं नहीं आ पाता हूँ बिकॉज माई वाइफ इज नॉट नोइंग एंड आई हैव योर कंपनी. देन ही टोल्ड अ वेरी गुड सेंटेंस. You need not come to office at all till your wife is fully cured or she is dependent upon herself. आप तब आओ जब वो पूरा अपने पर डिपेंड हो जाए और या ठीक हो जाए. But when you come with full mind to this office. ये बात उन्होंने बोला साथ साथ बोला first most important thing is that you should take care of yourself. आपके लिए आपका हेल्थ सबसे बड़ा इम्पोर्टेंट चीज है. नेक्स्ट कम्स टू योर फैमिली एंड थर्ड कम्स टू योर office, work and relatives work. So you give importance, but it does not mean that office and work is neglected. But when you want to prioritize, prioritize.
I also request the dignitaries on the dais to please present a memorandum to Engineer Sunil Kumar, Technical Officer NDRM, who has worked very hard for this conference. Thank you, sir. I request Dr. R. Kichuk, sir, to present the
water science. The Western Professor of the Engineering Medicine College, she has anchored, monitored the whole program. On behalf of Medicine College, on behalf of IDA, I request Chairman Sir to and Chief Guest to present moment to Spooti, Engineer Spooti, please. Thank you very much. You know, this task was given to her without any prior notice. She has, monitored. Yes, actually executed in a professional way. Thank you, Spooti. Thank you very much. Total show was in our control. And thank you, Spooti. Thank you very much.
Good evening to all. It is my privilege, honor, and happy to propose vote of thanks. Being the last phase and last item. So I am especially thankful to Dr. S.L. Jha, who is ADG ICR and have come specially with a personal request of Dr. Ish Kumar Sani. Although I remained in NDRI for my graduation and post-graduation, I heard his name, but I am lucky to have a face-to-face with him today. Dr. Sani used to praise him like anything, and I realized today, I think he is a god. And I found him completely out of box personality, manufactured by God for a special purpose. And I feel also that all those who are present, they are lucky and enlightened with the tips in the personal appointment as well as different of the dairy professionals. I have also got my answer to the thin attendance or thin membership, which I was pointing out yesterday in the AGM. First thing, he motivated us to propose that he want to become a member of our institute, our organization. So that's each year's for him. The second suggestion towards it, that is that we should think of starting BE in dairy engineering. So the more the numbers, so at least our some percentage will come to us, and we'll have more numbers. Thank you very much, sir, for your valuable tips as well as your motivational speech to the class. Regarding the 0.9% losses we suggested, I think that itself is a great amount, close to 1%. If total production is 170 million tons, if we take 1%, it comes to approximately 1.7 million tons. if we devote all of us towards that goal itself, so it will make a sea change in the economics of the dairy industry. Regarding his 15 tips, I feel his last tip, that if you can make yourself a thinking brain, then every other tips will follow it. So I suggest with this, that if you only work on at a time on this single tip for making yourself thinkable and reactive to yourself, which generally we don't give time for thinking to ourselves itself. So thank you very much for the 15 tips. I am thankful to all the delegates, participants, speakers, chairmans, co-chairmans, reporter for the complete seminar. Especially thankful, doubly thankful to the delegates who has remained till the end. I am also thankful to our co-partner, Bharat Media and Events, especially Mr. Bharat and Mr. Sunil and his team for giving us this platform to conduct and also to see the best city of India, clean city of India. I used to think that there cannot be any city better than Chandigarh. But I think it's right, Indore is a more cleaner and more better managed than Chandigarh. I am thankful to all the core committee, all the other organizing committees, and all the persons who has contributed towards execution of this seminar. I will fail my in duty if I don't mention the names of the advertisers and sponsors. Without them, it was difficult to make this show. Lastly, I also accept that there were some deficiencies which were beyond our control and request everybody to excuse us for the same. Lastly, I should not take much time and I thank all once again and wish you a happy return journey after taking lunch from the experience. Thank you very much. I will request first Dr. Manoj Kumar Gupta and Dr. Sarika, CSIR, AMPRI, Bhopal to receive his Justice Kripal Singh from NSDC. Next is Dr. Neeraj Tandon, ICMR. Next and last is Mr. Sunil Joshi, CDSCO Headquarters.
Once more, thanks from CDSU headquarters in Delhi and CDS of the firm Indore. Thank you very much, sir.
I have nothing to add to what Saab has said, you know. Just to compliment the efforts of CDSO and others, parties which have come here to showcase their products and to showcase their technology to the various people. And thank you very much, sir, to be part of this IDEA seminar. So much.